From Fitton Field on the campus of Holy Cross College in Worcester, Massachusetts, Charter Communications presents live coverage of New England college football. This afternoon, it's one of New England's greatest rivalries renewed as the fourth-ranked Massachusetts Minutemen visit the Holy Cross Crusaders. It's college football on Charter TV 3. Hello, everyone, and welcome down to the field. I'm Kevin Shea, joined alongside by Andy Lacombe. And Andy, Holy Cross jumping right into the deep end for their opener this year, taking on fourth-ranked UMass.
Yeah, and Tom Gilmore wouldn't have it any other way. UMass is in the national spotlight. They have been for the last 10 years. They've been a national champion. And Holy Cross wants to get their program back to that level, get back into the playoffs. It'll be a good measuring stick today against UMass.
The man who makes it all tick offensively for Holy Cross is quarterback Dom Randolph. And he will face a very stern test today as he takes on what one publication called the best secondary in the nation in UMass.
And Dom Randolph quickly rising on the all-time charts at Holy Cross as an all-time passer. This guy gets the job done week in and week out. He was knocked around against UMass last year, but he still threw for almost 300 yards. He is poised. He's got 10 300-yard games, but it will be a stern test today against this UMass defensive backfield.
And when you look at UMass, Liam Cohen has shattered every UMass passing record in just 3 years as a starter. He is a smart quarterback and a good decision maker, and threw for 3 touchdowns in their opener last week against Albany.
And how many times do you have 2 Walter Payton Award candidates in the game? You have that with Dom Randolph and Liam Cohen, 2 of the best quarterbacks in the nation going head-to-head tonight. Liam Cohen is Mr. Everything at UMass. He's shattering the record books. He's shattering some of the national record books at his level as well. He is a very smart quarterback, and he's got a little bit of an inexperience in his receiving core. It'll be interesting to see how he spreads the ball around. Jeremy Horn is a dangerous guy back there.
Defensively, a man that will certainly have his hands full today for Holy Cross is linebacker Marcus Rodriguez. He will have to not only stop the run, and Tony Nelson rushed for 171 yards last week, but he will also have to cover the mammoth tight end and Ian Jorgensen, who is 6'5 and 270 pounds.
And Rodriguez really had a breakout year last season. Came out, led the team in tackles. He's the leading tackler returning. He will have to be all over the football field. You talked about pass coverage, but also shutting down the middle of the field in that run, because Tony Nelson, a very physical and dangerous back, who just fires through holes.
And when you talk about a shutdown player on defense for UMass, that man is All-American cornerback Sean Smalls. He is their shutdown corner. He is one of the best in the nation.
Last week against Albany, Albany didn't even attempt to throw at Sean Smalls. He is that good. He is a shutdown guy. He's one of the 2 All-Americans in this defensive backfield. They've got 3 All-League players in this defensive backfield, but Smalls, very, very dangerous. He's dangerous if he gets the pick. He's dangerous to take it back. He's that athletic.
Holy Cross opening their season with a bang against fourth-ranked UMass. We're back with the opening kickoff right after this. Back, everyone. Holy Cross receiving a penalty for an illegal block in the back on the opening kickoff. Josh Jenkins took it back to the 25, but that will be marched back a deal, so Holy Cross will start from their own 11.
UMass won the toss, but they deferred to put their defense on the field first, and here's Jenkins, a talented kid, sophomore. He made a lot of noise as a freshman. He's a little scat back, a little water bug type of guy. He just bounces around. Made too many guys miss because a hold happened or a legal block happened as he was in the return.
Randolph from the shotgun on first down. The inside handoff to Mike Kielt. And that goes nowhere. The front 4 for UMass swallowing it up.
Here is Dom Randolph. He was knocked down 15, 17 times last year against UMass, sacked 5 times. His offensive line, a veteran bunch, will be tested because this UMass front 7, they get after it. 44 sacks a year ago. They had 3 sacks in the first game against Albany.
3 wide receivers set for Holy Cross. Randolph from the shotgun. Terrence Gass is the lone setback. Randolph looking left. Now to the right, has time, fires, and it is complete over the middle. It'll be a Holy Cross first down. Down to the 29-yard line goes Brett McDermott. It's Freddie Santana
for the Crusaders, and they will feature a lot of spread. Mike McCabe, Mike Bernanzani up front, Chris Smith, Chris Poole, and Mason Olson. Bernanzani is in for Aaron Nolan, who is hurt. Ryan McGuire, the tight end, Randolph in the backfield with Terrence Gass, John Brock, Luke Chmielinski, and Brett McDermott. And you also saw Freddie Santana out there as well. They will mix and match the receivers. Brock and McDermott, the two leading receivers, returning for Holy Cross from a year ago.
An 18-yard pickup, Freddie Santana, the sophomore, with his first career reception in a Holy Cross uniform. Randolph again from the shotgun, has some time going deep, and it is intercepted. A flag is down. Smalls on the return is brought down.
Randolph's pass
by
intercepted
McDermott,
by
but this
Sean
will probably
Smalls.
Be pass interference.
Flag down.
Well, you saw that Smalls wasn't even thrown at in the first week against Albany. They throw at him right away here in the first series, and he shoved the receiver out of bounds. So it'll be a legal contact or a pass interference against UMass, and Holy Cross will get the ball back. I misspoke a moment ago. It's Aaron Jones, not Aaron Nolan. I combined a couple of past offensive linemen here for Holy Cross, but Aaron Jones, the biggest offensive lineman out today. And we will look at Bernanzani and see
pass
how he fills in.
Pass interference. Number 16 on the defense. Bobby plays the spot of the infraction. Automatic first down.
Well, this is a pretty good opening drive for Holy Cross. They throw at the All-American, Sean Smalls, the player who Don Brown says was the best freshman athlete he has ever coached.
And Dom Randolph has had time on both passing attempts so far.
Randolph, quick hitter. Complete to Luke Chmielinski. And that is the first career catch for the sophomore Chmielinski. A pickup of 3 yards.
Dom got away with one here because Michael Hansen on the outside gets out into the lane and he just gets it through the outstretched hands of the defensive end to Chmielinski.
Hansen broke up three passes a year ago. Last week against Albany, he had three tackles and broke up the pass as well.
Back up.
Holy Cross with good field position. They near midfield. UMass is coming. They may have come a little too early. Randolph is going to tuck it and run. Looking for a block. Gets one from his tight end, McGuire. Dom Randolph into the secondary and down to the 31-yard line of UMass. And that'll be a Holy Cross first down.
They are going to get UMass for offside, so this play is going to stand up. And McGuire doing a heck of a job downfield.
20-yard run by Randolph.
Now Randolph sees the side of the field is open. It was open because the blitz came and opened that hole over there. And then McGuire doing as much as he can, and look at Randolph take that hit. This guy took a lot of hits last year, a tough, tough quarterback. Michael Hansen, Brandon Collier, Kyle Harrington, and Daniel Darnell Dallaire up front for UMass. Andrew Resende Gomes, Josh Jennings, and George Byrd. The linebackers, Courtney Robinson, Sean Smalls, Brian Ellis, and Jeremy Miles in the defensive backfield. Ellis is a new starter. He's a converted linebacker playing in the strong safety position, but he had a huge game, 10 tackles in week one. So he's filling out this secondary well.
Terrence Gass gets a yard. Brought down by Kyle Harrington, among others.
Establishing the run will always be a goal for Holy Cross because they are known with Dom Randolph as being a passing team. They get up and down with that spread offense, but a lot of times overlooked, Terrence Gass and Mike Keelt career both average better than 5 yards per carry. So a dangerous back, especially with Gass and that speedster up the middle.
There's Don Brown in the middle of your screen in his fifth year as the head coach of UMass. Of course, a Spencer native, was a standout running back at David Prouty High School in the mid-70s. Later coached at David Prouty at Northeastern as well. Blitz coming. Gass on the screen. And he is hit and dropped for a loss by George Byrd. Byrd had himself a good game last week as well. Six tackles. That was fourth best.
And it was Eric Dixon, the former St. John's quarterback here and from Shrewsbury. He's from Southbridge with St. John's Shrewsbury. Coming in with the blitz, forcing Randolph to let that one go. Almost blindly. Got Gass, but Dixon said he was excited to be back this week, and he knows he's going to blitz a lot from his rover position.
Dixon looks like he's coming again. He's up at the line of scrimmage right now. Randolph from the shotgun on 3rd and 10. Here comes Dixon. Gass picks him up. Under pressure, Randolph lets it go, and let's see if there is no flag on Smalls, as it looked like he got there a little early on the back of John Brock.
First incompletion for Dom Randolph. Right you are, Kev. Smalls had good aggressive coverage, and it looked like he may have been on the back. Here comes Dixon again, blitzing, and they bring a few guys from that left side. See Smalls just on that back a little bit, and they let him play it. It was George Bird and Dixon on the rush to Randolph's blind side.
Fourth down, Holy Cross is going to go for it. It would be a tremendously long field goal here from the just inside the 32-yard line, so it'll be fourth down and 10 for the Crusaders. UMass has been blitzing. They come again. Holy Cross picks up the blitz. Now the pocket collapses around Randolph as he tries to scramble, and he is brought down at the original line of scrimmage by Josh Jennings, the very active linebacker for UMass.
Well, Holy Cross going for it on fourth down. You might ask why Matt Partain has the leg to kick a 48-yard field goal, but he'd have to kick it into a stiff breeze blowing in from the end zone on that end of the field. So Holy Cross opting to go aggressive, and there wasn't much there. Randolph had to take basically a sack there. Looks like he lost a half a yard.
And now we will get our first look at the UMass offense. Liam Cohen under center. Tony Nelson is the tailback. Nelson coming off a 171-yard effort a week ago. Cohen over the middle, caught from Horn. And Horn has the UMass first down as he takes it all the way out to the 49-yard line before he is brought down by Anthony DeMichael.
UMass offensive line is huge. Vladimir Dukas, John Ein, Sean Colicchio, one of the captains, the center, Bob Gatek, is from Pepperell, Massachusetts. Ben Coblin, former basketball player at the other tackle. Ian Jorgensen, a big tight end, with Cohen, Nelson, Zardes, Cruz, and Horn in the specialist positions.
There was a 22-yard pickup. Here is Nelson, first carry of the game, and he is stopped after a short game. DeMichael coming up strong from his cornerback position to force that run.
Holy Cross had to fill some holes in the defensive backfield. The first up front, Brian Walwin, a veteran, Alex Carson, Moody Owimore, and Evan Bird in the linebacking core with Marcus Rodriguez. Andrew Cialino filling in for Ryan Stewart this afternoon. Sean Lampkin also there at the linebacking court. Mushawe is the veteran back there with Brown, with DeMichael and Johnson, two sophomores, DeMichael and Johnson, in the defensive backfield for Tom Gilmore.
Ryan Stewart, the second leading tackler on the Holy Cross team a year ago. He is out today. The pass is incomplete, but is it a lateral? Yes, it is. And Holy Cross had a good shot at it. Of course, it is very tough to get on top of that ball when it's bouncing around on the turf, but the Crusaders had a shot. It'll be a loss on the play of six.
And it's a heads-up play on the outside by the cornerback. Trying to see, you see DeMichael and others getting down after it. Along with 14, John Myrick down there.
Sanford was the intended receiver, so it'll be third down and long for UMass. Cohen will operate from the shotgun. Holy Cross is going to rush four. They get some pressure on Cohen. Cohen slips away from it. Now to his left, still looking downfield. Fires down the field, and it is complete. Down to the 24-yard line. Liam Cohen bought some time, and he found Julian Talley, the freshman, with a huge catch.
I'll tell you, Holy Cross is going to want this one back. When you have that kind of pressure, and Holy Cross did, Owimore in on him. Cohen, plenty of room now, and almost picked off by Alex Johnson, who went flying across, tried to make the pick. The tally there, and a big play for UMass, which could have been disaster.
34-yard gain on the play. Tally, his first career reception last week against Albany. Here is Nelson breaking it to the outside. Stiff arms the man, and is run out of bounds inside the 20 at the 19-yard line.
That's what you're going to get from Tony Nelson. Physical, bruising, running, and a big stiff arm right off the bat for the man who had 171 yards a week ago against Albany.
Tony Nelson is a guy who has waited his time, too. UMass has had some tremendous running backs recently. Steve Baylark, who's with the Arizona Cardinals. Last year it was Matt Lawrence. He was with the Chicago Bears during their camp for a little bit this year. This is Nelson's time to shine, and the junior certainly did that a week ago. Cohen on the roll, going for it all, to the end zone. Incomplete and almost intercepted by Michael Wright. Wright got a hand on it, and he almost picked it off.
Well, the Crusaders playing aggressively in that defensive backfield, like the going after, really just ball hawking right now. And it's good physical play in that end zone. We've seen the Officials letting some physicality go by. Darryl Brown locked up, a good physical coverage with Horn. And it goes the way of Holy Cross. Nice play by Wright coming across.
Third down and six for UMass. Cohen under center, four wide receiver set. Nelson is split out to the near side. Ball's on the ground. And Holy Cross says they recover. And the officials confer. Marcus Rodriguez recovers for Holy Cross. And the Crusaders have held in the red zone.
Well, best friends, Liam Cohen and his center, Calicchio, they are roommates, and they mis-exchanged the snap here. And Marcus Rodriguez sees it right away and gets on the football. Two things about that drive. UMass clearly making an effort to go after the Holy Cross secondary. Don Brown said earlier this week when we talked to him that they're going to assess the schemes that Holy Cross is throwing at him. They know he knows that Holy Cross had to fill some holes in that secondary. And he's making an effort right away to attack the secondary. And Holy Cross comes up with the turnover thanks to one of their linebackers.
Holy Cross with a four wide receiver set. Randolph to throw, has time. Underneath McDermott, and Brett McDermott's down to the 29-yard line, a pickup of eight. Well, the offensive line giving Randolph some time. Three of those offensive linemen starters from a year ago.
Well, this offensive line giving up just 14 sacks a year ago. You mentioned the big man, Aaron Jones, is not in there at left guard, but Mike Bernanzani is doing a tremendous job very early in this game, and he's getting spelled as well. Rob Petrosino is in there, so they're going to mix and match at that left guard position right now. Petrosino's at the left guard spot right now.
Randolph running the option. Terrence Gass balls on the field, and Gass able to recover. It will be a loss for the Crusaders of seven on the play, and will bring up third down and nine. Dom Randolph, 4 of 5 so far for 29 yards through the air.
One thing that sticks out is just how quick the front seven is of UMass and how quickly they get on the football. Brandon Collier, Darnell Dallaire nearly recovering that fumble. Terrence Gass wisely getting on it quickly.
Forcing Randolph to really pitch that early. Third down and nine. UMass showing blitz. Here they come. Randolph steps up in the pocket, fires over the middle. It is caught by Chmielinski for a first down. Out over the 35-yard line. And the sophomore, Luke Chmielinski, with his second catch of the day. And that is good for a Crusaders first down.
We've been saying it for 2+ years now. Dom Randolph so poised in the pocket. When the pocket collapses around him, Randolph stays focused on, keeps his eyes downfield, knows what's going on around him, and makes the play.
12-yard pickup on the play for Holy Cross.
Mike!
Block running now in the first quarter, 6:14 remaining. Fourth first down of the ball game for the Crusaders, so they have been able to move the ball against this vaunted UMass defense. Minutemen rush four, Randolph with time, almost intercepted. In and out of the hands of Dixon. And he almost picked it off on the same field where he played his Thanksgiving Day games while he was a standout at St. John's.
You know, I asked Derek Dixon, I said, you were a quarterback in high school. You didn't get hit that many times. St. John's always had a big offensive line. Now you're going out, you're blitzing on every down, basically, and trying to make hits on every play. He goes, well, you know, I was always an aggressive kid by nature. That was his response.
All right.
And he's playing aggressive out there right now, just missing the pick there, but a lot of run right now for Dixon.
5'11", 205, Dixon. The inside handoff to Mike Kielt, and Kielt gets forward for about 2 yards. New offensive coordinator this year for Holy Cross is Mike Padone. Padone is St. John's graduate himself, has been the offensive line coach and had been the run game coordinator for years and an assistant head coach, this year taking on the additional responsibilities of the offensive coordinator, and with that just coaching the tight ends for the first time in a long time, not coaching the offensive line. But you know that as a former offensive lineman and offensive line coach, he's going to try to get some runs in there and try to put something on the back of his offensive lineman.
UMass going with a little bit of a quicker blitzing lineup here defensively on third and long. Anthony Monette in the game along with Dixon.
And here they come, and they do in fact get to Dom Randolph, but the flag flies, and it may have been too early. Josh Jennings was coming off the corner, and Jennings.
Josh Jennings tried to time it. He tried to time it perfectly, but I think he was a little bit early.
Number two on the defense, 5-yard penalty, replay third down.
Regular.
Jennings just explodes off the line just a little bit early and gets on top of Dom Randolph in a hurry. You see just how quick Jennings is, but just mistimed it there. Now UMass will kind of switch things up. And now in the third and short, it's a different situation from third and long. Holy Cross has a few more options, but they go spread, big time spread.
Jennings led the team in tackles a week ago and had a key interception late in the game against Albany.
Wouldn't be surprised to see Randolph take this one.
Five wide receivers, empty backfield. It is a quarterback sneak, and Randolph does indeed get enough for the first down. And that may be one, too, where Randolph just has the option to tap his center, and they go on a silent count, and only he and the center know.
You just get up behind Big Chris Smith with the former WWE Nasty Boys haircut and just get up behind it. Chris Smith, a real character as a center and a leader of the line up there, and a nice job. They spread the field, and Randolph saw an opening and got enough for the first down.
Crusaders have converted two third downs in this drive. And it continues now with 4:22 remaining in the first quarter. Kielt has some running room, has a lane, and Mike Kielt has 5 yards. And what this is doing, Andy, more than anything else, you look at time of possession. It is a very humid day out here today. One thing that Holy Cross cannot compete with UMass is in the depth department. UMass can throw waves of big bodies and very talented players at them. So Holy Cross is gonna have to keep control of this ball and the clock.
No, absolutely right. And Holy Cross right now giving their defense a long rest. You know, this defense is gonna have to be aggressive. They'll take some chances throughout the day. Holy Cross's defense will to try to make some things happen. And right now their offense is controlling the clock, which is right where Tom Gilmore, I imagine, would like to be.
Second and four, Randolph. Looks left, fires incomplete, looking for Josh Jenkins.
Now, Holy Cross, they throw the ball a lot, but a lot of times it's a ball control passing game. A lot of shorter passes, a lot of high percentage routes. You know, generally, Holy Cross will have the ball with a lot of possessions in a game. They'll throw, and it won't eat up a lot of time of clock, time of possession.
UMass has won the last 6 meetings between these two teams. All time, the series history tied 21 all with 5 ties. First time since 1996 that UMass has visited Fitton Field.
It's been a long time since Holy Cross has beaten UMass. Last year, it had been a long time since Holy Cross had beaten Harvard. This would be an equally huge win.
Randolph gets it off to Kielt as he's going down. Kielt slips a tackle, flag flies. Mike Kielt has a first down, but we will see. There are 2 flags on the field, and it looks like this one will come back.
Complete the
field. A 9-yard. 9 yards from Kielt, and it'll be negated by a hold. How about Randolph, though? He's hit around the ankles, and he still stands and makes the throw.
Just great boys from Dom Randolph.
Holding, 66 offense, 10-yard penalty from the previous replay. Third down.
Mason Olsen is the guy they get just under siege on the outside, and it's Dixon. Eric Dixon's just causing havoc early in this game.
And they're blitzing Dixon from all over the map. I mean, he's not just going on the outside. They're putting him between the tackles and letting him go up in there and try to slant and take a gap.
He was excited about this game. He's a backup rover. You've got all Americans in front of you in the defensive backfield, but you know Holy Cross is in the spread, so he knew they'd be in a defense where they would be blitzing him a lot. He was fired up for this game and so far making an impact.
Third down and 14 for Holy Cross. Randolph with plenty of time, going deep, has a man open. First down and more. Down to the 30-yard line goes Bill Edger, the junior with his first career reception. And he is a big target at 6'3 and 196 pounds.
Well, Bill Edger played in 11 games last year, but that didn't make a reception, and this one was just, he just got lost back there in the defensive secondary. Bit of blown coverage from UMass. Safety Brian Ellis came in and made a big stop as Randolph was able to find him. Randolph getting time. to throw the ball.
26-yard completion, third down conversion of this drive for Holy Cross. We'll credit the offensive line with giving Randolph the time. Randolph being pressured, and he throws it out of bounds. Intended for McDermott. Wise move, and one thing about Dom Randolph is he is a very smart quarterback. Last year, 30 touchdowns against only 8 interceptions.
Right now, he's 6 of 10 for 67 yards through the air. Is Dom Randolph.
Don Brown.
Passing efficiency-wise, there's almost nobody better.
And Don Brown said last year, he said about last year, Randolph was one of the two best quarterbacks we faced all year long. And remember, they faced Boston College and Matt Ryan, who was the first pick and now is the starting quarterback for the Atlanta Falcons. So he is in some pretty good company. The senior from Amelia, Ohio. Underneath, and Holy Cross looking for a flag. Smalls on the coverage. John Brock on the reception.
Well, Holy Cross is showing right away that they are going to throw at Sean Smalls. No matter what.
He does seem to get there quickly, doesn't he?
He is quick. Smalls is quick, and he's been on Brock throughout the early part of this game. And Brock goes down and gets it. You know, Randolph doesn't have many places to put it when you have a guy as adept in his defensive back position as Sean Smalls. He can make a play and close quickly. 12th play of the drive for Holy Cross as they are chewing up some yardage and some clock here in the first quarter.
And let's see, we get a timeout on the field.
Timeout! UMass!
UMass calls for the timeout. We'll take a break and step aside from Fitton Field. Holy Cross in fourth-ranked UMass, scoreless. Tom Gilmore, the head coach of Holy Cross, with a big smile on his face. His team playing well now. He is in his fifth year at the helm. And across the way, there is Don Brown, also in his fifth year as the head coach of the UMass Minutemen. And Don Brown, already one of the winningest coaches in UMass history, is closing in on Mark Whipple.
Whitey George! Go!
He's third on the career win list. Incomplete as Randolph intended for Freddie Santana.
Well, Dom Randolph usually throws pretty well on the run and just misses his target completely there in Santana. You know,
Randolph,
you talked about, yeah, go ahead, Kevin.
You go ahead first.
You talked about the two coaches. I mean, I think you have two of the premier coaches in New England college football right now, in Don Brown at UMass and what he's been able to do. You know, UMass was on the national spotlight. Mark Whipple really started it off with the national championship in 98, and Don Brown has brought him right back to that level. Tom Gilmore, he has built this team with depth, and he's built the skill positions that if they have a big offensive lineman like they have Aaron Jones going down, they can fill it with some guys that can do the job.
Mark Whipple's son is the freshman quarterback on the UMass roster. Randolph has some time now, scrambles, fires over the middle to Santana. It is caught for a Holy Cross first down. Santana has his helmet ripped off. He's down to the 16-yard line.
UMass is thinking that maybe Randolph was over the line of scrimmage when he threw this ball. It was very close. As you see Randolph step up and then make the play to Santana. Phil Robar, statistician, believes he was over the line.
Well, but Holy Cross lost their top two receivers from a year ago in Thomas Harrison and Ryan Maher. So some other guys stepping up. And early on, you see a guy stepping up like Santana. Freddie Santana, Luke Chmielinski, two sophomores that have played well so far. Randolph to throw again. Incomplete and almost picked off, and he was drilled after he threw it. Smalls got a hand on it, but it was behind him. The intended
Randolph
receiver
pass,
was John Brock.
Now, UMass continuing to send blitz. They haven't really sent the house that much on Dom Randolph, but they're sending one or two guys against Randolph to try to shuffle him up. And just an ill-advised throw there for Dom. He maybe got a little signal mix up with the routes with his receivers.
Last year, Randolph attempted 62 passes in the UMass game. That's a school record. He may break that here this afternoon. Four wide receiver set. Randolph to throw on second and 10. With time to the end zone, caught for a touchdown. Holy Cross is into the end zone. John Brock on the receiving end. And the Crusaders lead it 6-0.
John Brock got free because it looked like he eluded Smalls at the line. Smalls, I think, was looking for some help in his secondary from the safety. It didn't happen because Holy Cross had three receivers back on that side of the field. And Brock was left alone for six.
Matt Partain was a perfect 50 for 50 on point afters a year ago. A school and league record. And he puts it up and through. 54 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Holy Cross strikes first. It is 7-0.
Brock is on the top of your screen, and you know they sent Kielt out in the flat. It almost looked like UMass was looking for that because Smalls was up at the line of scrimmage and Brock was left alone in that secondary.
Brock last year, the
actually,
fourth.
Smalls may have gone down, slipped on that play.
Fourth leading receiver on the team a year ago, John Brock. He was fifth best in the Patriot League with 45 catches for 537 yards and two touchdowns.
Yeah, you see Smalls getting up off the ground. He slipped down there, and that allowed Brock to get free.
And again, Randolph got time. He got time. He was able to look and see his open man. And look at this crowd. When was the last time that when you panned Fitton Field, you saw a crowd like this? It has been a while.
Good crowd on both sides of the field, and yeah, you'd have to go back. You would have to go back. Scoring drive, 15 plays, 79 yards, spans 7 minutes, 9 seconds. And it caps with Randolph to John Brock. And the Crusaders jump out on top. You know, Tom Gilmore talked to us this week, Kevin, about the fear factor and being comfortable with playing with a team on the national level like UMass, you know, the fourth-ranked team in the nation. Last year, UMass was the second-ranked team coming into the Holy Cross game, coming off of a national championship appearance the year before. He says, our guys showed that we could play with UMass. And then this year, I think there's a little bit more, not of a comfort level, because they know about the talent UMass has, but there's certainly less of an awe when they come up against a quality program like this.
And you've certainly seen that here in the first quarter. 54 seconds remaining. Matt Partain is going to kick it away. The very dangerous Courtney Robinson, number four, is back deep. He returned one 100 yards for a touchdown last year against Holy Cross, and the Crusaders pooch it up in the air. The fair catch is called for and taken there by Darrell and Fenner.
Partain's kickoff.
And UMass will start on their own 30, but that tells you a little bit about the respect that Holy Cross has for Courtney Robinson back there.
On that offensive possession for Holy Cross, 5 first downs. They converted 3 of 4 on third down situations, 1 of 1 on fourth down situations. So they really stretched the plays out a little bit there against UMass. And on that kick return, a lot of times you'll see guys going away from Robinson. There are other dangerous guys. A guy we know, Emil Guanagu, right in the middle there. He's the third man back. Got a kick return last week against Albany, a former Holy Name standout here in the city.
And the backup fullback, and flags fly here.
83 offense, 5-yard
penalty. Ian Jorgensen called for the false start, the tight end. It'll be first down and 15 for UMass from their own 25. With 53 seconds remaining here in the first quarter.
Well, you know, it looked like they were going to the run there with Tony Nelson. I think that's exactly what UMass has to do. I think they have to establish the run, and they have to try to pound out some yards here. Don't panic. There's plenty of football left. Try to pound away at this Holy Cross defense and then open things up for the pass.
Here's Cohen off of play action going over the middle. Has Horn. Horn's got it, and Horn is inside the 30 down to the 28-yard line. A touchdown saving tackle from Michael Wright.
So much for that idea to pound it out. But Horn, a guy who can stretch it, a transfer from Syracuse University, former Big East player there, and a guy who can really get down the field with speed. And you see Cohen just deliver the ball right on his hands. Perfectly thrown ball, leading his receiver well. And a good close to save a tackle.
47-yard strike. Cohen to Horn. Here's Nelson. Nelson surges forward and picks up 7 tough yards. Well, Albany jumped out to a 14-0 lead a week ago on Holy Cross. So you know that, I mean, on UMass, UMass, a veteran group, they will not panic and they will stick to their game plan and do what they expect to do coming in.
Now, this is a very experienced team in UMass, and you know they had a very tough practice schedule this week. Don Brown was on them all week long because he did not like the way they played against Albany.
And that is the end of the first quarter of play from Fitton Field. Holy Cross in front of fourth-ranked UMass, 7-0. working. Welcome back, everyone. Liam Cohen with Kevin Morris. Oh, Kevin Morris is the quarterback's coach and the offensive coordinator. That is not Kevin Morris. Kevin Morris, of course, was an assistant coach at WPI and then was the head coach at WPI. So a homecoming for him as well.
UMass 100 yards through the air, 4 yards on the ground so far.
There's Jeremy Horn. UMass graduated 2 1,000-yard receivers. So Cohen breaking in some new receivers as well. Last year, Horn had 12 catches and 3 touchdowns. This year, he is the man. Nelson plows forward. Jorgensen, the big tight end, helping to pave the way.
UMass is enormous up front. Their offensive line is big. They are largely a veteran offensive line. They only gave up 17 sacks a year ago, and they paved the way for Matt Lawrence, who had a huge year at UMass. Tony Nelson actually played in the Holy Cross game last year in a backup role, at 55 yards against the Crusaders in that game.
He averaged over 5 yards a carry a year ago, 92 carries for 486 yards. He also caught 9 balls for 45 yards. This is Nelson's year, though. Nelson gets the call, and he is brought down
Nelson
after
on the
a short
carry.
Pickup by Sean Lampkin.
Sean Lampkin made the stop for Holy Cross.
Lampkin's a guy who had experience last year as a linebacker. 22 tackles, a fumble recovery, including 4 tackles for a loss.
Well, they get a good surge on the right side of the line, and then Nelson puts a little juke step in the backfield. A big-time step from Nelson. You talk about this O-line, you see the guy with the on the right guard position with all the tattoos, 77, Ben Coblin. This guy played Division I college basketball at BU before coming back to Amherst, which is his hometown, and playing college football. Pretty good story there. And they think he's got a lot of talent there.
Cohen to the end zone for Horn. And he overshot him, incomplete. Talking to an NFL scout from the Arizona Cardinals before this game started. And I asked him who he's here to see. And that was one of the guys he's looking at, is Ben Coblin, the right guard for UMass. He said he's looking at both quarterbacks as well, looking at Dom Randolph, looking at Liam Cohen, and looking at Smalls.
Yeah, there are some NFL caliber players in this UMass team. UMass has not converted a third down yet. They are 0-for-1. Big play for Cohen in the offense.
Third down and 7. Holy Cross showing blitz. Here they come to the end zone. Incomplete, and the flag flies. DeMichael was on the coverage of the freshman Julian Talley. And this will be pass interference.
Well, to this point, they've let some physical play go in the secondary, but, you know, Talley got good inside position on DeMichael there, and there wasn't much that the cornerback could do to try to make this play. You see he's got that left arm around his waist, so a clear call, but you know what? It's 6 points if he doesn't commit the penalty. Now they're going to have to try to make UMass earn it from a yard away.
First and goal for the Minutemen from the 2-yard line. Chris Zardes is the fullback, the junior, redshirt junior from St. John's Prep. Nelson is the tailback. Nelson gets the call following Zardes, and he's brought down at the 1.
Nelson on the carry.
Good push from the front 7 of Holy Cross, including some members of the secondary. DeMichael came in there, and that's pad under pad.
DeMichael is just throwing his body around on the field right now, like a torpedo coming through to try to disrupt things in the backfield. And a good tackle right there in the middle of the football field. Andrew Cialino stepping up and making the play. Cialino, again, in that linebacking role for Ryan Stewart.
Second down and goal for the Minutemen. Cohen on the bootleg. Taking it to the corner, and he breaks the plane for the touchdown. Liam Cohen on the naked bootleg, and he won the foot race to the corner of the end zone, and UMass is on the board.
A really well-designed play to get UMass into the end zone. And Liam Cohen did just enough to get there.
Oh. Cucco. 4 for 4 in point afters a week ago.
Cucco for the extra point.
He is good, and we are all tied up at 7 apiece.
Watch the Crusader defense go to where they think the ball is, right in the pile there where Tony Nelson's going, and just one man to beat on the outside. Liam Cohen just gets past Alex Johnson. You know, Cohen, a big physical guy, so he's able to get out there and stretch across for 6.
And you look at that, and they don't pull anyone. UMass, everyone's pushing
right up the middle
and blocking
there
to the right side and really selling that fake, and Cohen sells it well. And it's just he and Johnson out there on the corner.
7 plays, 70 yards on the scoring drive for UMass. Took 2 minutes, 54 seconds. I have to confess, Kevin, it might upset some of the Holy Cross supporters out there in TV land, but I've always been a big fan of the UMass Minuteman band.
That's so, all right. That's
not
going
to... You know, at least they can play once today.
You're right. There they are,
and
too.
They are huge, they do a tremendous job at the basketball games and the football games, and just a solid team out there. They could feel the football team out there with the numbers they have.
Yeah, they certainly bring the numbers. They keep Peter Pan in business, the Peter Pan Bus Company. So UMass answers back, and we are all tied up at 7 apiece. Liam Cohen, the veteran, directing that drive, a 4-year starter. UMass, over the last 2 years, Minutemen have a 23-5 record. That is the best 2-year period in program history. And it is fielded by McDermott. Here comes McDermott. He's got a lane. McDermott's got some room to run. Foot race across midfield and into UMass territory, down to the 40-yard line. A 44-yard return.
And the fake reverse right off the bat, and that gets Horn, who's down there in defense, to bite on it just enough that Brett McDermott, and he calls himself the Jet, with apologies to Casey Goff, he said he's the fastest guy on the team, and the Jet gets the Holy Cross in great starting field position.
Just well designed. Look at the blocking, all the purple hats on, purple on white jerseys, and it's just man on man, and let McDermott use his speed, and that's what he did. Holy Cross running the option. Here's Brock, and Brock lowers his shoulder and picks up 9 yards.
Well, now Holy Cross is going to show a bunch of different looks against UMass, and this is what the Holy Cross offense has done over the last couple of years. Terrence Gass, fake handoff inside, and then it's option to the receiver, Brock, coming around.
Second.
Brock has that speed to cut up field. A big play on first down. Now you set up all kinds of things you could do here on second and short.
6'1" and 208 pounds.
John Brock. Back up.
Great athlete, too. He ran for 2,000 yards in high school. Here's Gass, and Gass will have a Holy Cross first down. And when you have those kind of athletes, and a lot of times you do have that, you'll have guys like John Brock, who was a tremendous tailback in high school, running for 2,000 yards, then gets converted to wide receiver. You have a lot of options with things like that. He was also a 1,000-point scorer in basketball, so he is a tremendous athlete.
John Brock and Darryl Brown went to the same school in Asheville, North Carolina.
Thank you.
A couple of guys that are really getting things done, the Asheville school, with a couple of alums up here at Holy Cross, playing big roles here down in their final year with the purple and white. First down for Brock.
So again, it's all set up by the tremendous return and the great field position. Brett McDermott sets it up with some great blocking. Holy Cross building on that, getting the first down. Now they're inside the 30.
And that'll just drive coaches crazy. You work hard, you put a score to tie the game up, and then you give up that kind of return that sets up Holy Cross in scoring position right out of the gate after you put 7 on the board.
Randolph swings it out to the side. Run out of bounds is Nick Cole. So Holy Cross going deep into their bench. Nick Cole seeing his first action on the receiving end of an 8-yard gain.
Randolph really spreading it around here in game 1. Nick Cole coming around. He came around from the other side. And a good gainer on first down. Second and short. And Holy Cross establishing the pass and the possession pass. High percentage pass to Cole, who had room to run.
Randolph from the shotgun. Here comes UMass. Toss sweep. Gass has some blockers. And Gass is upended, but not before he picks up another Holy Cross first down and is knocked down at the UMass 12.
9 yards on the gain for Gass, and it was big old Mike McCabe from his left tackle position, among others. But watch 69 coming out of his tackle position in front of Terrence Gass. Big 69 holding off the linebacker and allowing Gass, holding off the defensive back and Ellis, the strong safety, and allowing Gass to pick up that first down. But good blocks up front for Holy Cross.
They call McCabe Big Baby. He's a 6'5", 298-pound sophomore. Randolph with time, tries to check down over the middle to Gass. It was incomplete. Dom had time. He surveyed the right side of the field, didn't see anyone open, looked back to the left, and talked about that this week. He said, if there's nothing there, I'm going to have to be smart. I'm going to have to hit the check downs.
Well, it was a smart play, but Randolph will definitely want this one back because he may have just rushed this throw just a little bit, seeing the pressure coming late. And he had Gass open.
Last year, Gass had 27 catches for 318 yards and 4 touchdowns. He was fifth best on the team in receiving. Randolph, jailbreak, they throw the screen, and Gass is hemmed in after a very short pickup by Jeremy Miles, the transfer from Navy, and the all-league pick.
And they think Miles can do some things for sure, and he comes up and really makes a huge play, because if he doesn't make the play, Holy Cross has big yardage and maybe 6. Terrence Gass with a block trying to get out front, but he just can't get out in front. Vernon Zani cannot get out in front of Miles, who moves quick and comes up and makes that play.
Miles last week against Albany had 10 tackles. That was second best on the team. Had an interception, had a tackle for a loss. The UMass band making some noise down there in the closed end of the end zone. Randolph to the end zone for Cole. It is incomplete.
Got it.
A flag flies.
Yeah, you gotta call that. It came at the last minute because you'd think that McDermott could have come back and made that play.
Corey Davis was the man in coverage.
This is a play. Randolph just throws it up, relying on McDermott to get to the spot. And it was an underthrown ball. McDermott, when he tried to come back, was corralled by Corey Davis.
Dave Bolduc working the sideline camera, and he is right there, right on top of the action. So it'll be first down and goal for Holy Cross from the 2. Gass is the tailback. He gets the call on first down, runs through a tackle, and into the end zone. Terrence Gass barreled through a tackle at the line of scrimmage and burst into the end zone, and Holy Cross has reclaimed the lead.
Different formation for Holy Cross because they've had injuries on the line, and they've had injuries in the tight end and H fullback position. We'll talk about that in a second, but they get the job done in the short yardage.
Gass ran through the tackle of Josh Jennings, and that is not an easy thing to do. Partain on to the point after. It is up and good. And it is 14-7, Holy Cross.
Maybe no one more excited than, besides Terrence Gass, than Big 96, Anthony Campbell, reserve linebacker, leading the way as a fullback. He gets out way out in front for blocks, and that offensive line follows course.
Look at Gass, though. I mean, that's a clean hit by Jennings at the 4. And Gass just lowers his shoulder, keeps his legs driving. Well, when you talk about the difference between a lot of times staying up on campus and working out with the strength and conditioning coaches versus going home and working out on your own, that may be one of the biggest differences. You work out with your strength coaches, Jeff Oliver and his entire crew, and you have that kind of strength and that kind of leverage to run through a tackle like Gash just did to Jennings, and get into the end zone.
Absolutely, and that is a pretty sure-handed tackler in Jennings in that UMass linebacking core. See the scoring drive, 7 plays, 40 yards, 316. That's one thing we talked about with Terrence Gash though late last year. Not just an elusive running back, he's a guy that's really worked on, you know, squaring up and running through people as well. He's a tough, tough runner for the Crusaders, who have now put up touchdowns in their last two possessions.
And Jennings comes into this afternoon's contest as the leading tackler this season for UMass. He had 13 tackles in the opening game and then had 69, third best on the team last year. There is Emil Iguanagu, number 24, a former standout at West Boylston and at Holy Name High School.
He's the guy, freshman. He's in the back middle there, so if they pooch it, he could get a ball.
This one's going to get out of bounds. The flag will fly. Yeah, you do not want Emil Iguanagu with his hands on the football.
Well, they certainly don't want Courtney Robinson with his hands on the football, and that's why they're kicking away and kicking short throughout today in their first two efforts anyway.
Iguanagu. Iguanagu is just a beast at 6'1 and 230 pounds. You and I covered him in high school and watched him at West Boylston and at Holy Name, and he was a man among boys more often than not out on the field. And he has continued to develop and gain that strength, and his athleticism is just remarkable.
Yeah, he certainly is, and you saw Tom Gilmore with a word to Matt Partain about the next time they kick down. Partain pretty much saying, hey, listen, my bad, gives Coach a pat on the back. UMass has had tremendous starting field position in this game. This is their best of the game, starting at the 40.
Cohen, three-step drop, fires it out to Horn. Ball's on the ground, incomplete. Great defense by Michael Wright, who came up and put the lick on Horn.
The Holy Cross playing with a little bit of a swagger in the backfield. They gave up that big play to Horn, but they're going after people right now. Michael Wright with the play there.
Michael Wright is 5'10 and 153 pounds. Jeremy Horn, 6'3 and 190. What you're seeing right now is Holy Cross players really sticking their nose in. Second down and 10. Nelson gets the call. Nelson bounces to the outside. 45, knocked out of bounds at midfield, just across midfield and into Holy Cross territory.
Now, Holy Cross wanted a hold. They think they thought Chiellino was being held on the outside by Victor Cruz. There's the handoff to Nelson. See, it was Owemore who may have been held on the inside, not
Chiellino. Tom Gilmore's still on the sideline talking to the linesman. It'll be a first down for the Minutemen. Nelson brought down by Evan Bird.
Nelson on the carry.
Now, UMass can Marcus try to Rodriguez really establish the run by just pounding it behind this big offensive line. And Nelson, you know, he will be physical. He's not a guy who generally comes down with one quick pop. You know, Holy Cross in the last couple of years have really worked on their defensive depth, the depth at all positions, and trying not to wear down at the end of the game. A clear way to try to wear Holy Cross down is pound, pound, pound the football with that offensive line.
Cohen under center. Crusaders rush four, incomplete. DeMichael was the man who had a shot at it. It was intended for the freshman Tally, but it was overthrown.
Third down.
I think Cohen wanted Tally to go upfield a little bit sooner. May have ran a little bit too long of a route.
Great break on the ball by DeMichael, number 23, the sophomore, Anthony DeMichael. He played in 10 games a year ago. He had 6 tackles, but didn't have a ton of time. A lot of that was on special teams. But he has played well so far this afternoon. Third down and 7 for UMass. Cohen on a design roll. Fires, complete for the first down to Victor Cruz. And Cruz knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line. First catch of the day for Victor Cruz, and that's a guy that Don Brown talked about after last week and said we've got to find a way to get him the football.
Bumped out of bounds by Alex Johnson.
22-yard pickup here, and you said the designed roll. Holy Cross just putting four guys in the rush, and they set everyone else back. And, you know, when Cohen has that kind of time, receivers can find ways to get through the zone and get open. And that's exactly what happened here. Cruz just sitting down there in the middle of the field, and Cohen found him.
Cohen checking his wristband. Rolls out, it's a bootleg again, has a man across the middle, Horn. Horns into the end zone. Touchdown for UMass.
Cohen's pass complete to Jeremy Horn for the Massachusetts touchdown.
Well, Horn just came all the way across the formation on a deep post route, crossing route. And it was that bootleg rollout again. Cohen had the time, was able to wait until Horn could get through the middle of the field and found his man.
We've got ourselves a pretty good ball game here.
Armando
a little under 8 minutes left in the first
the
half.
Kuko will attempt the point after. It is up and through. 7:46 remaining now in the first half, and we're all tied up at 14.
Well, Don Brown said he liked the way Jeremy Horn played and looked a lot on offense last week. And the Holy Cross taking some chances in that defensive backfield, trying to jump routes. But Cohen just too good. He gets the ball right to his spot, and you can't give Jeremy Horn that much space. Horn, plenty of room between him and the safety helping out.
The Massachusetts drive, six plays.
And a little bit of pose at the end for the former Syracuse Orange. Now with UMass, you know, you look at this UMass roster, you look at the transfers from other Division One football FBS programs, as they call it now. You know, the Division One schools, you think about Syracuse, Navy, and others. And, you know, a lot of the other guys are redshirts, so these are veteran guys. They may be sophomores and juniors, but they've been in the program a little bit longer. Seven plays, 60 yards, the scoring drive for UMass. They do it quickly, just under 2 minutes. And they had good field position set up because of the kick out of bounds.
Last week, Horn had four catches for 37 yards and a touchdown. Picks up another touchdown reception this week. And in two games, it is very clear who Liam Cohen's favorite receiver is. Big Jeremy Horn.
And we're working our way into a little bit of an Old West shootout right now after some quiet first drives, four touchdowns in the last four drives, two for Holy Cross, two for UMass. And we could have ourselves a showdown here between the quarterbacks, as advertised.
And if we continue to throw the ball, as certainly as much as Holy Cross is, but UMass is throwing the ball a lot as well, we may be here till about 5:30 tonight.
They may need to put lights at Fitton Field.
Brett McDermott. Somebody. Fakes it again. McDermott trying to get to the outside, does. There's a wall of UMass players. He slipped through, gets a block. McDermott's across midfield, foot race to the end zone. Brett McDermott takes it in for six. 87-yard kickoff return. Brett McDermott answering UMass with a strike of his own. And the Crusaders have regained the lead.
The Jet turning on the afterburners and getting some huge blocks downfield. Quinton Liggins, 34, put on a block that sprung him. He also got a big block from James McLaughlin in that right side. And the Jet did the rest.
Oh my, is that a momentum shifter? Partain on for the point after. It is up and through.
They're not going anywhere. They're not going anywhere. Watch the blocks McDermott gets downfield. He does a little of it himself. Fakes that reverse. It doesn't bite too much for UMass. 55 makes the first block up front. Now watch 34 coming to the screen. Liggins, 34 here. Boom. Touchdown, because the Jet with the juke does the rest. You got to beat the kicker, and the big man does. Big block from Liggins. That is a huge play for the special teamer. Doesn't see a lot of time on defense. He makes the play that springs McDermott for the touchdown.
And then the speed of McDermott. Look at McDermott turn on the jets. Well, this is where it all comes to fruition here. He has the patience to stay on his feet, keep his head up, and look for the seam. And when he finds that seam, he can accelerate as quick as anyone.
He used his blocks, McDermott did. He got a good block, a couple of good blocks by McLaughlin, because he made a couple initial blocks to get McDermott over to that side of the field, and then he kept going. And then Liggins with another block and a big block, and Brett McDermott with good vision getting downfield.
Well, last year, UMass allowed just over 19 points a game, and that was one of the best in the conference and the country. Holy Cross has already struck for 21 points today. Now, a year ago, the Crusaders averaged 36 points a game, so they're a team that is used to scoring.
And it's the second big play on special teams for Holy Cross in a row. So special teams right now, a big part of this game.
And another kickoff that goes out of bounds.
And it's a big part going against them as well.
Yeah. Tom Gilmore not going to be happy with that.
So another kick out of bounds. Gilmore is probably going to have some more words with Partain. He's headed that way. They're really making an effort to get it away from the guys back there at Robinson. You see, and now Gilmore's going to have another word with Partain. Yep. They may switch the strategy up here because, you know, you give them the 40-yard line every time. It's still a pretty short field for UMass. UMass has started their four drives, the 31, the 30, the 40, and here on the 40 again.
Hand off to Nelson, and Nelson is swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. The Holy Cross defensive line standing their ground. Brian Walwin, the man on the tackle, and Walwin's the big fella up front at 6 foot and 260 pounds. He started all 11 games a year ago for Holy Cross, had four sacks, and that was tied for first on this Crusader team.
And Holy Cross doesn't sack a lot of quarterbacks. That's something that, you know, it hasn't hurt them too much, but they need to still get pressure on Liam Cohen.
Cohen with time has Horn, and he overthrew him.
Jeremy Horn is big time. He is big time. He put a move on Michael Wright, and he was in the clear. This was 60 yards. This was a 59-yard touchdown pass if it went through. And Cohen just overthrew him. He put a good move on the cornerback, and he has 10 yards on the cornerback right there, and that would have been six.
Liam Cohen, 5 of 10 for 147 yards. Has run for a touchdown, has thrown for a touchdown. Cohen on third and nine. Pressure coming, gets it off underneath to the freshman. And Talley is dropped after a pickup of four.
The sophomore, DeMichael, is not showing any sophomore concerns. He's playing aggressive football, and that's a big open field tackle to force UMass into a fourth down situation. Watch 23 come into your screen, get around the ankles, and make the tackle.
How big of a defensive stand is that for Holy Cross? UMass starting with excellent field position on their own 40 after Holy Cross has the 87-yard kickoff return to take the lead, and the defense holds a booming punt from Brett Arnold. Jenkins fields it at his 10, gets upfield across the 20, across the 25 and the 30, and Jenkins brought down at the 38-yard line. And now the Crusaders will have tremendous field position. Anthony Monette, the man making the tackle, the Spencer native and former David Prouty standout.
Now Sean Spencer, the special teams coordinator for UMass, is going to have a fit because they had a chance to pin UMass, or did pin Holy Cross deep. And Jenkins gets it back, and you see the Spencer strongman, as he was formerly known. Monette come across and make a big hit.
31-yard return. There is Josh Jenkins. He certainly is a weapon. And Spencer, you mentioned the special teams coordinator for UMass. He was an assistant coach here at Holy Cross. So he knows some of the members of this staff.
Knock it down, down.
Ryan McGuire, the tight end, with his first catch of the season.
Great house pass to Ryan McGuire.
The fifth-year senior from Woburn and Arlington Catholic. And an all-league player a year ago. Picks up 7 yards.
And in the spread offense, the tight end sometimes gets lost. But McGuire, all-league, he's a very talented guy. He can, you know, as a pass receiver.
McGuire's just a guy who has battled injuries throughout his career. Last year was healthy for the first time. Put on some weight this offseason, and he really gives Dom Randolph a nice target across the middle and finding those seams in between the linebackers at 6'4 and 230 pounds. Randolph, here comes the rush.
Ah!
Underneath, Santana has it and room to run. Santana brought down at the 32-yard line. I don't see a flag. That was, oh, there is.
Yeah, they're going to get Holy Cross for a pick, it looks like.
I was looking to see.
It was,
a
pretty good one.
Near side.
It was a pretty good one. It was the flag was called from well off the play. Well off the play, but it's the right call.
Negates a 22-yard pickup from Santana, the sophomore.
Offensive pass interference, number 11 on the offense.
15 yards previous.
Rock set a big-time pick. He said a big-time pick. It came from the UMass sideline is where the flag came in. So UMass sideline may have gotten a pretty good call in there on the official, but that is the right call. It was a clear pick coming across.
So Holy Cross will be set back now. And the Crusaders will be looking at second down and 19 with 4:45 and counting remaining here in the first half. McGuire goes in motion. Randolph rolls out. Chmielewski has it. And Chmielewski is out to the 49-yard line. He will be very close to a Holy Cross first down. It appears he has it. It appears with the spot that he has the first down.
I'll talk about taking that penalty and then just rolling with it. Holy Cross and Dom Randolph finding Chmielewski, who is now having what you could call a breakout game, because you know you get your first couple receptions of your career here. That's going to get him in the media guide for sure. And
you're
a big
kidding.
First down for Holy Cross.
Holy Cross running a lot of flood routes, getting 2 and 3 guys out there in that 8-16 yard ratio. Underneath Cole with the catch, he squirts forward. They're going to rule him down at the 41 of UMass, and that appears to be another Holy Cross first down.
Right now, it looks like they have UMass's defense a little bit confused because they're throwing 4 or 5 receivers out against them, and UMass has a couple of guys in the middle of the field who are just looking around trying to find somebody.
You saw
and left alone is Cole.
Yeah, you saw a nice block from Mike McCabe at the top of the screen there. That's just one-on-one. McCabe is left one-on-one. The left tackle, he makes a nice block. Tom Gilmore, the head coach on your right, Mike Padone in the dark hair on your left, talking things over. Randolph under heavy pressure. It's a screen to Gass. Gass has some blockers and room to run. Inside the 25, Terrence Gass has a Holy Cross first down, and he is all the way down to the 19 of UMass.
Well, the big guys were out in front, weren't they? Chris Poole
and
Chris
Smith. Chess match. Right now, Holy Cross is winning the chess match. They're coming on the blitz. The perfect call is the screen.
Watch him bring it. Poole just pretty much gets Miles out of the way. He doesn't really put a block on him. And then Chris Smith following down. Look at the big guys getting out in front. And Terrence Gass just does a lot. Eludes the tackle. And he shows just how tough he is to take down.
Quick shot out to Brock. And Brock gets inside the 15, down to the 14-yard line. Smalls on the tackle. That's just using Brock in the size there. It's 6'1", 208.
Brock's going to shuffle off a little bit there. Looks to be all right. But, yeah, you know, physical one-on-one play. You got he and Smalls on an island, and let Brock try to muscle the All-American.
You got to say right now, Mike Padone is calling a great game as the offensive coordinator. Second down and 5, really spreading the plays around. Randolph has thrown for 163 yards. 15 of 21. Dom checking off his play at the line of scrimmage. 4 seconds on the play clock. Randolph hands it off to Kielt. And Kielt just slides inside the attempted tackle of Dixon, gets inside the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal for Holy Cross.
Well, Holy Cross really has to put the big man up front, and this experienced offensive line getting a surge. Look at the guys up front. Vernon Zani leading the way from his guard position, pulling out another up front.
That is the 15th first down for Holy Cross today.
Timeout,
Holy Cross. We will take one alongside the Crusaders in front of UMass, 21-14. You are watching exclusive coverage of Holy Cross football on Charter TV3. Dom Randolph looking at first and goal from the 9-yard line. Holy Cross in front, 21-14. Randolph rolling to his left, fires out there Santana, and he is collared, but not before he breaks the plane. Touchdown, Holy Cross. And the Crusaders lead it by 2 touchdowns.
Dom Randolph rolling away from the blitz and finding the open man. And Brock was hurt on the play.
Brock
as he comes off, he's coming off under his own power, but Santana putting it in for 6 more.
And you hope that it's just a cramp. I mean, it is very humid, very
hot.
Yeah,
you know what, he shuffled off the field after he caught the pass earlier in this drive, similar to this, so.
As Holy Cross,
it looks like that's what it would be.
Needs the services of John Brock, but what about the way the Crusaders are playing right now in every facet of the game, offense, defense, and special teams?
Well, you know, you're right about the way the offense is calling the game right now, and Coach Padone, because the blitz coming, and it's a roll by Randolph away from the blitz. Open some space, there's less defenders on that side of the field. And Santana able to extend around the pylon. See the blitz coming from Randolph from the right side of the Holy Cross line, and Randolph goes left and makes the play.
And more than anything else, you have, right now, you have got to feel the confidence that this Holy Cross offense has. Mike Padone, the offensive coordinator, his first year as the offensive coordinator, and he has called so far an exceptional game. And, of course, his players are executing flawlessly.
7 plays, 61 yards, a little over 4 minutes on that drive. Minute 49 left. Now it's crucial for Holy Cross to make a play here on special teams and keep UMass off the scoreboard. You've got all the momentum going your way here for the last quarter. You want to keep that going into the locker room.
Tempo 6, UConn nothing in the third.
You really can't make any mistakes against a team like UMass. You can't make too many big ones.
No.
And expect to win. Holy Cross right now playing a very strong first half.
Courtney Robinson and Jeremy Horn back deep to receive. Partain kicks it away. It is Robinson at his own 5. Robinson straight up the middle. Here goes Courtney Robinson. Stiff arms the kicker. Robinson is run out of bounds at the Holy Cross 37-yard line, and a flag flies late. And that is why Holy Cross does not want to kick it to Courtney Robinson.
And the flag probably will be against Holy Cross for offsides on the kick. And it is. Will be deferred, or will be denied by UMass. And the danger. This is the danger of Courtney Robinson, who took one back 100 yards against Holy Cross last year. And a saving play by Charles McCall on the outside. Look at the speed, the explosiveness of Robinson.
Great blocks too. Warren Wilson, number 1, was out there, a wide receiver, leading the way and staying on his block. And that's one of the things that UMass kickoff return team did right there is they stayed on their blocks. It wasn't one hit and let your man go.
And the field position continues to be good for UMass. Best starting field position. Now at the Holy Cross 32. They haven't started inside their own 30 yet.
Cohen to the air underneath.
Liam Cohen's pass.
And that is caught. Joe Sanford on the reception. 6-yard pickup. Yeah, now starting at the 40 doesn't seem so bad, does it? Clock is running, under a minute 20 to go. The screen to Nelson.
That's a hold on the outside, and they got away with it. Jeremy Horn had a good-sized chunk of jersey in his hand. And the men who make the man who matter didn't make the call, and that's their choice, but it's a first down for UMass.
Anthony DeMichael is number 23. He's the man who's trying to get free.
DeMichael is really shifting his body around in there, but could not get out of the hole there. And here's
to Horn, six. And that's Liam what Cohen's you get with a veteran quarterback like Liam Cohen. He does not get rattled. He does not panic. Has a lot of confidence in his own ability, and, well, he should. He was the league's player of the year last year, the preseason player of the year this year, the Walter Payton Award candidate. And he hooks up with Jeremy Horn for the second time today, and UMass is back within a touchdown.
Well, the one mistake UMass may have made, they may have left too much time on the clock for Dom Randolph and the offense. Still a minute to play here in the half. Well, this was set up by the little screen, and Horn just was able to throw a move on, and he's done this twice now. This time, Cohen connects with him. Throws a move and gets upfield. He shows his athleticism. And he is having himself some kind of game here right now on the road. There's just not many people that match up in this area with Jeremy Horn.
No.
Three plays, 32 yards, 47 seconds. UMass scores quickly. It's the one thing Holy Cross didn't want to do is give UMass a little bit of momentum going into the half.
So now this Holy Cross kickoff return team has been absolutely spectacular themselves. And we'll see if they can't give their offense some good starting field position to make one last run at it.
Certainly possible with the way they've been playing. Coach Gilmore is fired up, but you get a sense he's having a lot of fun with this team this year.
Oh, you see it. You see it in practice with the offensive line, and you know, he is smiling a lot, and that means usually not only that he's having fun, but that he's got a lot of confidence in his team and what they can do this year.
And the team's doing things right, because Coach will get on guys for sure. He's tough, but the guys love playing for him here at Holy Cross.
Short kickoff, Terrence Gass at his own 25, slips the tackle in another, spins through three tackles. And Gass takes it out to the 32-yard line, a 9-yard return. And he just saw a wave of white jerseys.
You get a sense that UMass is going to be doing a little bit extra hitting drills in practice this next week, because Don Brown can't be happy with the team, the way his team is tackling right now. Holy Cross just eluding too many hits. Guys going in with heads down and just arms thrown out and not getting around the body of Gass.
54 seconds remaining in the first half. Holy Cross still has two timeouts left. They are in front, 28-21. Run! Run! Here is Gass, and a flag flies.
Terrence Gass on the carry. Penalty marker down.
Generally, it's a hold when it comes from the umpire back there, and that's what it will be. Hold against Holy Cross as Gass really changed his field to get through the hole.
Holding 67 on the offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. Replay first.
Let's go, D. 49 seconds now remaining here in the first half, and you would expect
with the ball after the penalty. Yeah, with the ball and with the penalty now, Holy Cross will not take any chances. and run this thing out. And if you can go into the half 28-21 over UMass, I think preseason, I think last season, I think any time in this situation, you take it.
Yeah.
Let's go, D.
Mike Kielt is the running back for Holy Cross. The Crusaders with a two tight end set. Kielt gets the call straight ahead. Gets forward to the 24-yard line. And it appears Don Brown will be content to let the clock run out as well. That ought to be the final play of the first half.
It will be. Holy Cross is already headed towards the locker room. The Crusaders, though, with a touchdown lead going into the half.
Dom Randolph will take his crew to the locker room. Holy Cross, right now, shocking fourth-ranked UMass. The Crusaders lead it 28-21 here at the half. We'll be back with all of our halftime activities right after this. There's your first half statistics. Holy Cross outgaining UMass in total yards, 235 to 207. And look at the rushing yards. Both teams have been doing the majority of their work through the air. Time of possession, of course, turnovers as well. UMass with one turnover, and Holy Cross did not turn the football over, and that's one of the keys. It's a key any game, but especially when you're taking on a team like UMass, ranked fourth in the country. And since the beginning of the 2005 season, Holy Cross has been winning that turnover battle. They are a plus 26 coming into today's game. So now make it a plus 27.
They won five games last year, just about five full football games without turning the ball over. And they really built up their margin. The other thing there, the one sack, that was on the first possession for Holy Cross. A fourth down play, it was a loss of half a yard. Holy Cross's offensive line has done a pretty good job of protecting Dom Randolph.
Little chip shot, fielded and knocked out of bounds. Shane Viveros, the defensive back, fielded it. Holy Cross, as you would expect, not going to kick to Courtney Robinson. They did once in the first half, and Robinson made him pay.
Well, again, still good starting field position for UMass. You know, at their own 38-yard line. They haven't started anywhere inside their own 30 yet in this ballgame. But, you know, you try to kick it short or you kick it out of bounds, and this is where UMass starts. If you try to kick it long, you saw what Courtney Robinson did to you in that first half. Set up a touchdown.
Liam Cohen brings up his troops. They trail it by a touchdown. That naked bootleg again. Cohen has time, has a man, Victor Cruz. He is into Holy Cross territory, still on his feet. And Cruz run out of bounds by DeMichael at the Holy Cross 24-yard line. Well, last year, Victor Cruz had one catch. Last week, he didn't have a catch. Don Brown said, we need to get him involved in the offense, and they have done it here to start the second half.
And just pinpoint passing from Liam Cohen as he's able to find Cruz. And Cruz able to create some space because, really, the defensive back, Johnson, had to take a different angle on him because he knew he wasn't going to defend the pass. He had to take a different angle to try to run him out of bounds.
38-yard completion. Cohen to Cruz, first down for UMass at the Holy Cross 24. And it is Nelson. And Nelson plows forward for 5 yards. Well, you can bet that it was a very animated coaching staff in the UMass locker room at halftime.
They were animated this week in practice, and it's going to continue regardless of how this thing finishes. You know, Don Brown is, you know, really works his guys hard, and it pays off. UMass is a national contender for the last several seasons, and they've got a lot that they can look at in game film today already.
Cohen with time, going for the end zone, and Cruz, incomplete, almost picked off by Wright. Michael Wright had the best play on the ball, but that is great coverage by Wright.
Intended for Victor Cruz, Michael Wright on the coverage.
This ball thrown out in space for Cruz to run under, and Wright got there first, just in time to break that up. Looked like Cohen had overthrown it, but Cruz really closed on the ball, and Wright looked like he was the only one who's going to be even close to it at one point in that play.
Third down.
This is a big down early in this half for Holy Cross's defense.
Cohen will go from under center. Empty backfield, three wide receiver set. Looks to his right, fires to his right. Caught by Cruz. Sean Lampkin just delivered a bone-jarring hit, and Victor Cruz somehow hung on to the football. Oh, Lampkin just lowered the boom.
It's a big pop that might make Victor Cruz think twice the next time he's running out in the zone, but it's a first down, and it's a great job by Cruz to protect the football.
That's a de-cleater. But Cruz hung on, and it is a big first down for UMass at the Holy Cross 13. Nelson bounces to the outside, and he is cut down there. Darryl Brown, the co-captain, came knifing in from his safety position and makes a terrific open field tackle.
Top 10 in tackles last year for Holy Cross in a backup role, and he comes up and establishes himself against the run. Darryl Brown really establishing himself in the spring as a captain. Played well in spring practice and now a leader on this defense.
Worked exceptionally hard this summer as well. One of those guys that stayed up, and they had about midway through the summer about 60 guys staying up to work out, work on their games together. The pass is a quick hitter, and Horn hurdles a man and gets inside the five to the 4 yard line. It'll be fourth down. Third down, rather.
Throwing pass complete, Jeremy Horn.
Now, UMass trying to show a few different looks now. A lot of play actions. And a real just quick hitter, quick release from Cohen as Horn came in on a little receiver screen. Away from the play action fake.
So well designed
West Coast
play.
Offense look there from UMass.
Taking advantage of an aggressive defense trying to get up the field quickly. Nelson on the carry, follows his fullback, spins through a tackle and into the end zone. So UMass opens the second half with a long march for a touchdown, and the Minutemen are within one.
Well set up through the air. They're setting up their power running game with their aerial attack as UMass. And it was set up with a couple of big plays to Victor Cruz, Tony Nelson punching it in.
Kuko on for the point after. It is up and it is good. He was perfect last week, 4 for 4. He is a perfect 4 for 4 here today. And we are all tied up at 28.
Now here you go, just strong power running. And you see the vision of Nelson as he did not want to take the corner, cuts it back up in the middle and plows in for 6. Fullback Sarda leading the way, gets a good ceiling block on the inside, and that's where Nelson eventually ends up into the end zone.
Nelson has good vision too. Let him drift a little bit and he just looks for the scene, and then, you know, you can smell the end zone, the good running backs can, and Nelson is one of them, and he was not gonna be denied. Spun through one tackle and then powered forward into the end zone, and we are all tied up at 28 apiece. So now it will be back in Holy Cross's court to answer. The Crusaders have never trailed today. Brett McDermott and Josh Jenkins back deep to receive for Holy Cross. Armando Kuko will kick it off for UMass. McDermott already has an 87-yard return for a touchdown in this game. Short one, it will hit and go out of bounds. And Holy Cross will start from their own 40, so the Crusaders will have excellent field position.
Now they're clearly kicking away from McDermott, going to Jenkins' side, and Jenkins doing a nice job of letting that one find the sideline. Special teams, two special teams units right now that are a little bit maybe gun shy, not taking any chances against the opposing return teams. And it sets up great field position for both offensive sides of the ball Holy Cross now with good starting field position at the 40.
Crusaders will come out in a three wide receiver offense. Terrence Gass, the lone setback. Randolph operating from the shotgun. UMass rushing four. Randolph over the middle, incomplete, and almost picked off. It was intended for McGuire, and it was Jeremy Miles who broke on the football. Brian Ellis, the strong safety, coming in.
He jumps the route here and playing back there in the center field spot, if you will, and jumps in, jumps the route, and nearly comes away with the football. Probably should have come away with the football there. Again, a converted linebacker, Ellis, in the strong safety spot for UMass.
Ellis created a turnover last week. He forced a fumble to go along with 10 tackles. He was the second leading tackler on the team. Randolph going for it all for McDermott. Incomplete. Good coverage on the play. Courtney Brown was running stride for stride with McDermott. Courtney Robinson.
Well, this is, let's just go speed against speed and try to see if we can get McDermott free over the top on an island with Robinson. Good one-on-one coverage. Holy Cross is 3 for 5 in third down situations coming in here.
The UMass
long drive earlier in the first half, they converted several big third downs to get into the end zone.
UMass players trying to get their fans into it, and they oblige. Third and 10 for Holy Cross. Here comes UMass, and they get to Randolph. It will be an incomplete pass, but they did indeed get to Randolph very quickly as they were collapsing Michael Hansen and company. Josh Jennings in there as well.
Well, good pressure on both sides. Dixon coming from one side. Looked like Hansen on the other side, and Hansen gets up around Randolph, and this is, believe it or not, the first punt of the game, and the first time we've seen the punter for Holy Cross. Mike Holloway
to return for the Minutemen.
And the very dangerous Sean Smalls back deep to receive. An NFL prospect. Smalls lets it hit and fields it. A room service hop at his own 21. Bird knocks him out of bounds as the flag flies late.
Smalls on the return. Penalty marker down.
Now, special teams has been a real X factor in this game, hasn't it? 39-yard punt, 7 yards on the return, but it's a penalty against UMass. It's going to push them back to their worst field position, believe it or not. Starting field position of the game.
23, block in the back, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
You'll see the block right there. 23, Viveros.
Yep.
With the block in the back against Kielt. There's a Crusader on the ground, and that is looks like Alex Johnson.
Well, that's the starting free safety for Holy Cross, Alex Johnson down. The sophomore, one of those new starters in there, he's up and walking off the field under his own power, and that's certainly a good sign for the Crusaders.
Yeah. Looked like a cramp for Johnson because he was trying to stretch it out immediately when he went down.
Last year, he played in 5 games, had 3 tackles, an interception, and a fumble recovery.
This is the time of year where you'll see it. You'll see it in the high school games, the college games, on a hot, humid day. If you're not properly hydrated, there will be cramping throughout, especially late in games.
UMass offense, Nelson, straight ahead for 2 yards. Alex Carson in there on the tackle for Holy Cross.
Tony Nelson on the carry for Massachusetts.
Now UMass is in a situation now where it's all even, and they can try to establish themselves like they tried on that first drive. The first drive, remember, spread offense, a lot of passing. Now, a little bit more of that run game and the ground game. Tony Nelson, don't forget, had 171 yards a week ago. Guy who can really pound it.
Cohen will go from under center. Three-step drop, fires it to the left side. It is caught. And DeMichael right on horn. Nice coverage by Anthony DeMichael. as he closed quickly on the thrown ball.
Yeah, and you have to get on top of Jeremy Horton right away. Otherwise, he will make you miss. If he's able to turn around and square up, he's going to be able to bounce off a lot of guys because of his size. DeMichael comes up, cleans him up really quick.
Certainly did wrap up well. Coach is always preaching, wrap your arms, and DeMichael did it right there. Early going in the third quarter now, just about 10 minutes remaining. We are all tied up, 28 apiece. Kevin Shea alongside of Andy Lacombe. We're pleased you could join us. Tip to the line of scrimmage, and it falls incomplete. Almost picked off by Lampkin. He had a shot at it, but Holy Cross getting some hands up at the line of scrimmage in the passing lane. Alex Carson, the 6 foot junior, deflecting the ball.
And doing a nice job because Holy Cross only brings four. They bring four men up front, plenty of time to throw, and Carson gets the hand up. And then it's a free ball out there, and Jorgensen almost gets back to it. Crusaders force a punt.
Brett Arnold punting to Josh Jenkins. Jenkins on the fly, gets through one tackle to the 45, cuts it up across midfield, and is dropped at the UMass 47-yard line, and the Crusaders will have excellent field position.
Anthony Monette, another special teams tackle.
He made the tackle, and he got up, and he pushed another guy, too. He can't get enough contact.
You can't be pushed around. If you're going to get in it with the Spencer Strong, man, you got to watch out. But how about Josh Jenkins? This is a guy, listen, you kick to him on the kickoffs, he can make things happen, but on the punt, he's back there alone. And he just finds ways to elude people. Now, he's not that big a guy, so it's sometimes easy to squeeze through smaller holes there.
Randolph will go from the shotgun. McDermott in motion. They hand it off to Brett McDermott. He's got blockers in front of him. First down and more to the outside. McDermott cuts it back and gets inside the 30 down to the 27-yard line. It'll be a Holy Cross first down.
The jet on the jet sweep. Coming across, Brett McDermott. And Holy Cross, you know, we talked about it with Brock earlier as another Crusader is down. It looks like it's Mike Keel. They will mix and match and have their receivers do some work running the football. Brock ran earlier.
That's a 20-yard gain. And again, it's the play calling and mixing it up, getting the guard and tackle out in front. And then McDermott has such great field vision. He's able to find the seams. He's very patient, waits for his blockers. Mike Keel being worked on here. And you touched on it earlier, Andy, but the loss of the fullbacks, the H-backs. Holy Cross been hurt by some injuries. Kevin Golden was the starting fullback / backup tight end. He's injured, he's out. Paul Nielsen was the backup tight end. He's out, and Holy Cross did work on a lot of two tight end sets early in the year, and then they lost Nielsen and Golden to injury, and Keelt going off under his own power. That's a good sign as a very good crowd here for Holy Cross's home opener.
Yeah, they
Crusaders
can't.
Holy
Cross cannot afford to lose Mike Keelt at this point. Mike Keelt's been snake bitten by injuries throughout his entire career, along with Terrence Gass. Talking about two guys that could really, you know, be burning up, putting up some big numbers if they were healthy. Brett McDermott, 141 all-purpose yards already, all over the field.
The Johnny Turco Award will be given out to the game's MVP at his homecoming. And that time, big Kyle Harrington put the lick on Dom Randolph.
Randolph's pass.
He just pancaked Dom after he got rid of the ball.
And Harrington had four sacks a year ago, seven tackles for a loss and a safety.
UMass's front seven, 27 and a half sacks coming back. That's more than Holy Cross's entire defense had last year. And those are just the guys coming back from UMass that are starting on this team right now.
Randolph from the shotgun on second and 10 from the UMass 27. Here comes UMass and they get through. It is Jennings. Josh Jennings, the linebacker, got through. Well, they brought a lot, and Randolph upset with himself. He is sacked all the way back at the 40-yard line.
Dominic Randolph stopped in the backfield.
It'll be a loss of 13 on the play.
That's a big mistake to take a sack like that, but Jennings is so quick. And this is the first, you know, the second sack by the Minutemen, but the first big one that really hurts. Yep. As Jennings just shoots through, and there's really not much. Randolph sees him too late. And that's maybe why he's a little upset with himself, as he just sees Jennings coming at him too late as he's scanning the field. That first sack, it was a turnover on downs. But this sack really puts him out of field goal range and could have some harmful effects on the offense.
UMass rushes four, and they get to Randolph again. Brandon Collier with the sack.
Randolph stopped in the backfield by Brandon Collier.
And now that front four is starting to really establish themselves on this drive, and they have been kept quiet by the Holy Cross offense throughout. And Brandon Collier comes right up the middle, and he just fights through the blocks on the left side of the Holy Cross offense.
Sean Smalls
getting through McCabe and getting to Dom Randolph. Just a power rush.
Fourth down, Holloway will punt. A high hanging short kick, and it goes out of bounds at the UMass 31.
How's the legs doing?
Nope, they're gonna say the 25. One official's trying to spot it at the 31. One spots it at the 25. It's gonna be the 25.
Just 19 yards on the kick. But again, 25-yard line, UMass is going to feel like they're in the shadow of their own end zone by the way where their offense has started throughout this game. Holy Cross with an opportunity to try to pin UMass back, create a little adversity, and they're unable to do that in special teams.
So Liam Cohen trying to drive his squad to another touchdown. He did on the first possession here of the third quarter.
Bye-bye.
Cohen, straight drop, looking left, fires for Horn, it is complete. That is a great throw and catch. Liam Cohen did not have a big seam to try to squirt that one through, and he threaded the needle, and Horn pulls it down.
Well, that is what Horn can do at 6'3", and you're going up nobody taller than 6 feet in the Holy Cross secondary. And Cohen fires it on the mark again.
28-yard completion. Cohen to Horn.
Jeremy Horn having a big night, big afternoon here.
Quick hitter to Horn. And DeMichael is right there for a great tackle. He closed again, no gain on the play. He drove Horn backwards, but they're going to say forward progress was stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Now, read well by DeMichael there. Come right away, close on that receiver. That ball is just kind of thrown. That was, I couldn't even call that really a duck. That thing was fluttering. That was almost like a shuffle.
Well, they hit Holy Cross for a big pass, and then they're thinking, I think, maybe we'll catch him in a little bit of zone defense and catch him backing up at the snap, and
tell you,
no
Liam,
such luck.
Cohen has thrown some pretty on-the-mark balls, but that one was ugly.
Cohen off of play action. Firing for Cruz, and he has it. Cruz gets a foot down, and it is a great catch for Victor Cruz, who's out of bounds at the Holy Cross 33.
And, you know, it comes right back with an on-the-money pass to his receiver on a deep out. That picks up a first down. Let's look at Cruz easily getting
it's great
two
camera
feet
work.
In, perhaps.
15-yard.
Definitely got the one that was needed.
Completion.
Again, though, this entire game, no pressure on Liam Cohen. He's been pressured once this entire game by a Holy Cross defense.
See if the Crusaders don't try to start sending people. This time it's Nelson following the block of his fullback. And Nelson with a pickup of 6 yards.
In the situation where Holy Cross has sent someone, they had Marcus Rodriguez on top, or one of the linebackers right on top of him early in the game. Cohen was able to elude it and find a big hit downfield. Now they can just pound it to Nelson and try to wear away on this defense of Holy Cross. It's a big difference up front when you're talking 300 pounds across the board in the offensive line for Holy Cross. It's 250 and under in the Holy Cross defensive line.
Quick throw out to the side. breaking tackles in for the touchdown, Joe Sanford. Sanford just broke two tackles on that play and gets in for the touchdown, and UMass has their first lead of the ball game. Sanford, a converted quarterback, getting a score here. Right now, this momentum squarely on the side of UMass, and it started with the Courtney Robinson kick return back at the end of the first half. The point after is up and through, and so the Minutemen with their first lead of the ball game, they take a 35-28 lead. Cohen to Sanford, and now this is where either angles or tackles, you cannot arm tackle a man, and Sanford runs through an arm tackle and gets into the end zone.
Ladies and gentlemen,
just a little quick wheel route almost. And he gets a good block out in front of him.
Sanford caught a couple of touchdown passes last year. A former quarterback came to UMass as a quarterback.
That's a great block from a fellow receiver out there. It may have been Victor Cruz, who was locked up on a defensive back. It was Keemon Bailey, actually, the man who had that nice block out in front. So the UMass drive.
Six plays, 75 yards, 218. And UMass has taken the momentum here and silenced this Holy Cross crowd, a big Holy Cross crowd. Phil Robo thinks Holy Cross still has the momentum. He's shaking his head at me right now, but I'm telling you right now, UMass has the momentum big time. Holy Cross needs to put up points in this drive.
They do. They need to, and they need to possess the football for a little bit.
Again,
give their defense a little bit of a break.
No time to panic. Do what you do well. Run your offense and try to take a little wind out of the sails here at UMass.
Fielded by one of the up men. And that's Anthony Campbell, the linebacker. Cohen with his ninth career 300-yard game. He is 17 of 23 for 307 yards and three touchdowns already today.
The all-time everything, really,
yeah,
at UMass. All-time quarterback at UMass. Of course, Dave Palazzi, third on the list in total yards at UMass.
And that's incredible because he graduated in the 80s.
Palazzi did it in the 80s. And now he's still third on that list. Of course, he coaches up at Leominster now. He used to coach at Millbury. High school football and a great standout from the North County, yep, in his high school days himself.
And was a guy that initially was looking at Holy Cross. Wanted to go to Holy
Cross. Wanted to get to Holy Cross. Ended up going to UMass.
Here. And yeah, he did a lot of great things while he was a quarterback at UMass. We talked to Jim Andreoli before the game, and Jimmy remembers some of the great battles they had with UMass during his playing days here at Holy Cross in the 80s. Here's Brock. And the UMass defense right there is a face mask. Face mask call will negate a solid defensive play because the Minutemen had three players right there.
Really well defended play. The Holy Cross has thrown this at UMass a couple times now. And UMass had it completely defended. And the face mask at the end of the play is really going to hurt because tremendous defense. And it's a personal foul variety. So an automatic first down, 15 yards. Pitch out to Brock. See the three guys on the outside eluding, Courtney Robinson eluding his block on the receiving court. And there's the face mask by 45 there at the tail end of the play, George Byrd. That hurts. That hurts big time for UMass.
Byrd was tied for fourth on the team in tackles a week ago. Part of that 28-16 win over Albany.
Wider Besson!
But the face masking call giving Holy Cross some breathing room and a first down. McDermott goes in motion. Randolph has to unload it. And he was looking for McGuire, his tight end. But Randolph could not step into that throw because of the pressure. He had to throw that one falling backwards.
Off his back foot, had nothing on the pass and just really had to get rid of it. McDermott was sitting down short and was open. but he went downfield to the tight end. See McDermott right down there, but he couldn't get anything on it. He just wanted to basically heave that ball out at McGuire, but there was really no shot.
Randolph checking off at the line of scrimmage, changing the play. Four wide receiver set. 3 seconds on the play clock. Dixon on the blitz, got some pressure. Chmielinski, and a flag flies late. Chmielinski picked up 8 on the play, but will this come back?
It's really late, and it's probably going to, it's in the middle of the play. Holy Cross likes it, but if it came against Holy Cross, it's a personal foul. People getting mixed up in the bottom of the pile.
Well, if you're Holy Cross.
Personal foul, 98 defense, 15 yards to the end of the run. First down.
Kyle Harrington.
Well, it's a nice job by Mike McCabe. He's a big left tackle, and he's got to get Dixon to the outside. He gets him out just enough that Randolph can deliver a perfect pass on the outstretched arms of Chmielinski. And then the personal foul came after that pass was made, right in the scrum. Getting into it with the offensive line was Kyle Harrington from UMass, and he picks up the penalty. 6th penalty against UMass for 64 yards.
So Holy Cross will have it 1st and 10 from the UMass 31. Randolph again, changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Toss sweep to Kielt. Kielt broke one tackle, could not break another, and is dropped after a pickup of 4 yards. It was Shane Vivieros on the tackle.
Well, check option at the audible at the line of scrimmage from Randolph pitching this one out. Kielt, you know, normally he's an in-between the tackles runner. He's getting to the outside a little bit. Nice open field tackle by Viveros to save a couple more yards. Kielt was running well.
So it is 2nd down and 5 for Holy Cross, and the clock continuing to run. UMass showing blitz. Here they come. Randolph with time underneath to Gass. Dixon on the tackle, and he may have dropped him just shy of the first down. It will be very close. It appears from the spot that Holy Cross will have the first down. Well, Dixon's showing you all facets of his game. I mean, he's able to rush the passer going up against some of these big tackles like Mike McCabe, who's 6'5", 298. Then he's able to go man coverage against a guy like Terrence Gass, who's 5'8", 192, and can fly.
Yeah, and Gass gets the inside on him. Dixon just a half a second on his reaction behind Gass, and that's enough for Terrence to pick up the first down.
Dixon is a very versatile player, and one that I'm sure John Brown and his staff love having in their defense. Like a Swiss Army knife, you can plug him in so many different places. Terrence Gass makes a man miss into the end zone for the touchdown. Holy Cross has answered back with a score of their own.
Oh yeah, Terrence. Huge. Huge.
Well, the Crusader offense has answered the bell.
That's a big response, and it started way back with that personal foul face mask on the first play of the drive.
Matt Partain puts the point after up and through, and we are all tied up at 35 apiece. You mentioned penalties, the face mask, the personal foul. That's 30 yards of penalties in that drive.
Holy Cross shows so many different looks. UMass defended that little reverse to a receiver earlier in this drive. They showed Brett McDermott going there. It froze the outside guys just enough to give some space for Terrence Gass to get inside and use his speed up the middle of the football field. The UMass defense reacted to Brett McDermott coming around as if he was going to take a little reverse handoff. And it froze one side of the defense enough. And then Terrence Gass putting on a nice juke move in the middle of the field to get himself free.
And it wasn't even a lot of dancing. It was one quick move. He's still going north and south the whole way, so not giving anyone a chance to close on him. You look at Matt Fanning there, the assistant coach, his first year as a running backs coach. And he has got to be pleased with the way that Terrence Gass and Mike Kielt have played so far today. Matt Fanning, of course, played here at Holy Cross. Had himself a great senior year as a wide receiver. His father was a longtime assistant coach here.
Big crowd here at Fitton Field. The rain, the tropical storm, the humidity. It's got to be like 98% humidity here.
Yeah.
You can tell by the puddle of sweat at your feet how warm it is. Dom Randolph, 19 to 31, 190 yards so far. He's going to have to throw a lot if he wants to match his record of 62 attempts from last season. Look out here.
Onside kick. Just over the outstretched arms for Holy Cross of Chandler Fenner.
You know, I thought UMass was going to try it the last time. I was waiting for one of the special teams units to try something. And because of the problems they've had with kick returns, to try a little onside kick and catch the other side napping. This one just misses out.
A lot of fat dripping off the turkey up here.
It's hot. It's warm.
As Carlos Garcia, veteran boxing trainer Carlos Garcia would say.
Dave Bulldog on the field with the field camera is going to have to eat probably his standard half gallon of ice cream on a Saturday to get back up to his normal weight.
Just to get his equilibrium.
Yeah.
He's gone through a couple pairs of couple t-shirts.
Order
already.
Order up a
today.
Half gallon of black raspberry for Bulldog.
UMass will start right at midfield. Nelson on the toss sweep, and Darryl Brown comes up and cuts him down for a loss. Well, Brown read that play, and he just closed very quickly.
Darryl Brown playing the role of Casey Goff, a guy in the safety position who defended the run so well in his career at Holy Cross. And now Darryl Brown is in that spot, and he comes up and does just what Goff would have done. Come up, attack the run, get low, and get the ball carrier behind the line of scrimmage.
You mentioned Brown played at the Asheville School. He's from Stone Mountain, Georgia, and he said high school football around there is like religion. It is unbelievable. Nelson met and dropped at the line of scrimmage, and now it is the Holy Cross defense flexing their muscle.
And you know what? He might get half a tackle on this one, but big Don Matheny, 75, right there, lifting his buddies up off the ground. He really made that play happen. He blew up his block in the middle, and Nelson ran right into the side of Matheny. When Matheny was injured last year, he was playing very good up front for the Holy Cross defense, and that definitely hurt them down the stretch.
Yeah, he played the first three games and then suffered the season-ending injury. Don Matheny, 6'1 and 315. Cohen under pressure, and he throws it short of Cruz, and the Holy Cross defense has held. Jeff Oliver, you don't think he gets fired up for these games. Did you just see him down on the sideline?
He just head slapped somebody down there. I don't even know. Is he calling plays?
It seems like he was getting the special teams players out there, and someone was a little slow on the uptake.
Oh, baby. And you know what? This one, just a little bit of a rush job from Cohen. He knows it. He knows he made the mistake there. Had more time to throw.
Brett Arnold averaged 47 and a half yards a punt last week. Jenkins at his 10, gets some blocks, and Jenkins dropped at the 20, make it the 21-yard line. Anthony Monette has been an assassin on special teams.
Monette might be the bright spot on the UMass special teams coverage, but number 50, Perry Townsend, lick 'em stick, coming up, boom. And Holy Cross, not in awe. They are delivering some blows here this afternoon. Watch 50 come across. Look out.
Oh! ATK. Your ear hole hits first, and then your shoulders, and then the cleats come down sometime after that.
42-yard punt. It was a good one, but a 12-yard return gets Holy Cross out of the shadow of the end zone.
1:19 remaining in the third quarter. Randolph slings it out to Gass. Gass makes two men miss. And he is dropped after a short gain. Anthony Rozier there for the stop.
You know, part of it is just the elusiveness of Terrence Gass, but Don Brown is going to be looking at film and telling his guys, getting them on the tackling a little lot. A lot of missed tackles out there. And Gass just picks up, he does a lot of work, picks up just a yard to do that work. It was a well-defended play by UMass, and they get to the ball so quickly. That's why you see a lot of jerseys ended up piling up and making that hit. They are in a fast defensive unit.
A little work on Terrence Gass's helmet. Dom Randolph rolling to his right, design roll. And Brock held on. Oh my. John Brock just got drilled and held on. And the UMass player may have gotten the worst of it, Brian Ellis.
Ellis is wondering what kind of truck he ran into. He looks like he might be a little bit out right now. This is a big time hit.
He may be out on his feet.
You got Collier coming at you. Boom, big hit. Yeah, he delivered the shoulder in there. It's a solid hit. And for Brock to hang on, that's something. Holy Cross going to the fourth quarter, tied with UMass and with the football.
Does it get any better than this? Don Brown, the Spencer native and former David Prouty standout, third on the all-time career wins list at UMass with 37 wins. Mark Whipple has 49. He is next up on the list. Third down and two for Holy Cross. Randolph has time, goes underneath. Incomplete. Billy Edger, well defended by Smalls.
Randolph's pass intended for Edger.
Now you know what? That was the situation with the spread on that side of the field, where Randolph choosing to throw, but he may have been able to run for this first down.
Same thing, same exact thing.
So another punt here for Holy Cross here in the second half. But that third quarter, a big one for the Crusaders. And they're gonna need to kind of keep the defense fresh here in the fourth in this first possession.
UMass looks like they're setting up a return for Sean Smalls.
Look out.
And the kick is hits and goes out of bounds. You see where they spot it at the 37-yard line, and that's where the UMass offense will take over after a 33-yard punt. UMass with 347 yards of total offense, Holy Cross with 292. The Crusaders 198 through the air, 94 on the ground, and UMass with 307 passing yards and 40 rushing yards.
Great atmosphere for football here in the second oldest Division I college football stadium in the nation.
And you couldn't tell by the press box, could you?
Couldn't by tell our, by looking up here.
By our broadcast booth, we are in a shed high above the field. Better move some rakes and shovels out of the way. It's a screen. And Holy Cross right there to sniff it out. Kyle Mashawe, the veteran, one of the veterans back there in the defensive secondary.
I haven't called Mashawe's name that often because you don't, he's their lockdown guy. He didn't get test, not getting tested a lot on his side. That time he's on Horn, he comes up, steps up, and makes the play to defend.
Mashawe last year tied for first on the team in interceptions with four, and second on the team with passes broken up. He had five. It was a loss of four, second down and 14. Cohen to throw, has time, to the side, caught by Cruz. Out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
Good chunk of yardage. You lose four, you get 10 back, and now you got a manageable third down situation for UMass. This ball just a bullet delivered by Liam Cohen. And Victor Cruz has been waiting for his opportunities, and he's getting them in this game. UMass just 2 for 8 on third down, coming into this situation here.
Holy Cross with 10 men in the box. Now they back off a little. Cohen to throw, flag goes down, and it'll be a hold against UMass. Sanford on the reception, but this one is probably gonna come back.
How about Moody O'Heorn coming through? And he did it on his own on a four-man rush.
He's the one who drew the hold because he blew by his man. Moody, a sophomore, coming right through and drawing the hold because of the great speed move. Now, he played in the UMass game last year and had a tackle for a loss, so he has some experience against UMass, but he's really getting a start here because of injuries in that front four, front three, front 7 minute, if you count everybody, basically, for Holy Cross.
Yeah, Nick McDonald, the starting defensive end, out with an injury for Holy Cross. Owe Moore had 8 tackles a year ago. Liam Cohen's going to call for a timeout.
Yeah, there it is.
And he's telling his team, just relax. We will take a timeout as well. 13:05 remaining here in the game. We are all tied up, 35 apiece. Welcome back to Fitton Field, everyone. Holy Cross and fourth-ranked UMass tied up at 35 apiece. Third down and 15 for the Minutemen. Liam Cohen from the shotgun, the all-time passing leader in UMass history. A Peyton Award candidate. Cohen pressured, fires, incomplete. Holy Cross got some late pressure on Cohen. He had to unleash it before the wide receiver, Bailey, made the cut on his route, and he overthrew him.
Well, that time Holy Cross brought a linebacker in addition to their big men up front. And it was Evan Bird who applied the pressure, 44, forcing Cohen to just kind of blindly throw that one out to a spot, just missing his receiver.
Josh Jennings to return for the Crusaders.
Big defensive stand from Holy Cross.
Jenkins, ball hits, and he will have to get away from it. And UMass downs it at the 23-yard line.
46-yard punt, another good punt. Now the UMass is Brett Arnold.
Well, we mentioned 6 punts last week and he averaged 47 and a half yards a punt. Last season, he averaged almost 38 yards a punt, 37.9 yards a punt. So he has stepped it up this year, Brett Arnold, the 6-foot, 185-pound senior.
Holy Cross is going to come right out, no huddle, and try to move on UMass right away. The offensive line is a big series for them. They kind of come back after getting it taken to them a little bit here in this half.
Run!
Inside handoff to Gass, and a shoestring tackle at the line of scrimmage. Gass picks up 2 on the play, but it was Bird who had him right around the shoe tops.
I mean, this offensive line, Holy Cross, has really done a tremendous job, with the exception of really one series. So you got to say they're doing well by Dom Randolph and the running game. Haven't been able to really get a sustained running game other than that long touchdown run from Gass in the last possession.
Guys, back off that sideline, please.
Clock continuing to run. 12 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the game. Second down and 7 for the Crusaders. Gass on a wheel route, well read, well defended by UMass in a late flag, and that is going to hurt Corey Davis.
Absolutely.
Came in and made the stop, and he carried Gass out of bounds about 5 yards and held on, and the late flag. Now, UMass has already been whistled for 8 penalties for 84 yards, and Don Brown is certainly not going to like this.
That's a horrible decision from Davis, who did a tremendous job defensively.
First down, Holy Cross.
He did a great job defensively here to corral Gass and get him out of bounds. Out of bounds, whistle blows, and now he shoves him, and it was like a half shove. He hears, it's like, oh, wait a second. Is anyone going to catch me? It was a half shove.
You know when you're going to get
just
caught.
Just a mistake there.
You do that on the other team's sideline, and that's where you're going to get caught because you're going to get that big reaction.
I've seen a lot worse that haven't been called, but that one, the right call.
9 penalties for 99 yards against UMass. Brock goes in motion. Tipped at the line of scrimmage and incomplete.
Right.
Michael Hansen, I believe, was the man who got a hand on it.
UMass right now very aggressively attacking these short little passes. It might be worth a quick look. If Holy Cross can get a little bit of pass protection, a little pump and go, and you may have somebody downfield.
Second down and 10 for Holy Cross. Here comes Dixon on the blitz. Randolph under pressure, gets it to Jenkins. Jenkins spins away from one tackle, gets through another across midfield into UMass territory, and that will be a Holy Cross first down. Josh Jenkins just did a lot by himself on this.
Josh Jenkins is 5'7", 143. And he is so elusive. He just cannot. He just doesn't get tackled on first contact. Four guys lay hands on Jenkins before he goes down. Here's one spin out. Ellis gets away from him. Gets through another. Three, four. Unbelievable. Smallest guy on the field making big plays.
Keel on the inside handoff. Not a lot of running room. He will pick up a yard and a half on the play.
This game is a battle right
now.
Yeah,
it is.
There are bodies flying all over this place. People are flying to the football. There's some little shoving after the fact. This is a battle right now.
This is a good old-fashioned street fight right now.
Talked about a test for Holy Cross. This could be a big test down the stretch for the fourth-ranked team in the nation.
It is right now. Dom Randolph, second down and 9 for his team as he changes the play at the line of scrimmage. 4 seconds on the play clock. The option to Keel, and Dixon is right there. What a game Eric Dixon is having, the Southbridge native and former St. John standout. He has been all over the field.
And I don't think you're gonna beat UMass to a corner because of the speed of their defense, and Eric Dixon is able to get out and make a sure tackle. He has been all over the place for UMass and having a great game.
Well, Dixon was a great running quarterback too at St. John's. He was a guy that they would give the green light to, and they designed runs for him because of his speed.
Holy Cross has not converted a third down situation this half. They're 0 for 3.
UMass showing blitz, and here they come. And batted down at the line of scrimmage.
Looked like Harrington got his big paws up there and made a big play. And right now the defenses on both sides are starting to assert themselves.
Yep.
35 points put up on each end, and the defenses are playing with some fire here in the late going. Harrington just getting up and winning the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
And now it'll be
Holy Cross trying to draw UMass offsides with a fake punt look here. They may take the penalty. They are. They're going to take the penalty field position wise and try to put a boot under one here.
Well, it makes sense from Holy Cross's standpoint.
Play a game in the offense. Five yard penalty. Still fourth down. Caleb Glover in the punt for Holy Cross.
The new punter for Holy Cross is Taylor Glore.
Guys, get it back up, boys. Let's go. Back
Mike
up
Holloway had been the punter. Taylor Glore will punt it here. He may be the coffin corner specialist.
He's not even in the two deep for punters right now.
Well, he's got Sean Smalls, the dangerous receiver, standing back, and he fields it at his own 14.
That's a great punt.
It gets out of bounds.
It does what it needs to do. It was returnable. That's the only mistake, but it pinned the UMass return into a corner and didn't allow the big play.
The Holy Cross coaching staff liked it.
Yeah, very well done. He got his job done.
So now the UMass offense, Liam Cohen, the all-league player, threw for over 3,000 yards last year, 30 touchdowns, 14 interceptions. Last week, 10 of 20 for 92 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Get out.
92 yards, very pedestrian-like for Cohen, but he has done that and then some here. And a long gainer on first down. UMass going into their bench. Octavius Hawkins, who is listed as a quarterback.
Now we've seen this play action roll out, roll away from the strong side. Tom Mashawe having to hang on as Hawkins running well. 24-yard pickup for UMass on first down.
Come on, baby.
Now it is Nelson trying to get to the outside. He does so. Turns the corner, first down and more. And Nelson finally brought down at the Holy Cross 33-yard line.
Well, good time assignment blocks up front for UMass. Boom, boom, big hit from Coblin, 77. And then what Nelson does is he says, the hole's closed, I'm going to bounce it outside. And he gets a good block on the outside from a receiver and picks up, no, big yardage for another first down.
Yeah, 19-yard run from Nelson, and that's just his 17th carry of the day. So Nelson, you would figure to be relatively fresh. And that's a bonus for UMass.
He didn't look like he had quite the explosion there.
Nelson again, brought down by Marcus Rodriguez.
Tony Nelson on the carry.
But it's easier said for me up here.
Marcus Rodriguez on the stop for Holy Cross.
On getting around the corner. He's a big physical bruising back. This is where he does his work, right up the middle. Rodriguez making the tackle.
Clock continuing to run, under 8 minutes and 5 seconds remaining. Holy Cross in fourth rank UMass, all tied up at 35. Going to throw. Holy Cross blitzing, he unloads it.
What a grab.
It is caught. Oh, sensational adjustment on the football by Julian Talley while it was in the air.
What a grab from Talley. He made a better adjustment on the ball than the defensive back. And he comes down with a first and goal situation. Time for Cohen, who gets rid of it with purple jerseys in his face and a great adjustment on the football.
It'll be first and goal for UMass at the Holy Cross one.
I'll tell you, it just seems like if the ball's anywhere near the receivers, UMass are coming down with the football. These receivers, really inexperienced coming into this year, making plays out there.
Emil Iguanagu in the ball game now. Cohen rolls, fires, touchdown. No, he dropped it. It was intended for the fullback, Chris Zardes. And Zardes dropped it. He caught 2 touchdown passes a year ago. Last week he had 1 catch for 16 yards, but he dropped this one in the end zone.
And Zardes made a great lead block on the last touchdown, and it definitely had earned a shot of scoring himself, and he doesn't come away with that one.
Former Globe and Herald All-Scholastic at St. John's Prep. Second and goal from the one. Iguanagu goes in motion. They give it to Nelson. He tries to leap over the top, but he breaks in. Touchdown, Nelson, and UMass has taken the lead.
That is a big scoring drive and a lot of physicality on the drive from the UMass Minutemen offensive line. Emil Iguanagu helping lead the blocks there on
there
that play as well, 24. Leading
right
Tony
down.
Nelson into the end zone.
Armando Cuco on for the extra point.
Cuco on for the point after. He is 6 for 6 today. And UMass has a 42-35 lead.
Nice push. Nice push.
Well, they tried a little action pass on the first attempt. This time it's just power. Iguanagu on the outside sealing the block, and then Zardes up front leading the way. 47 like a battering ram going through and falling in is Tony Nelson. So now 42-35, 7:14 left. This game feels a lot like Harvard last year, doesn't it?
Attention, alumni, family, it
certainly does. And special teams. Sure, now you're looking for the Holy Cross kickoff return team to come up with something big to give their offense some good field position.
Immediately following today's game.
Now, it's one of those games where both coaches will have plenty to talk about with their teams. Sure. There's the look at UMass's drive. 7 plays, 75 yards, 2 minutes, 9 seconds. And they just move the ball down quickly. Liam Cohen is throwing the ball in spots right now, and his receivers are making plays, whether it's the right spot or not. They're making plays. He's thrown some very good balls in this game. He's thrown some balls that his receivers have made tremendous plays to make the grab, and that was the case that set up the touchdown in this particular drive with Julian Talley.
Brett McDermott and Josh Jenkins back deep to receive for Holy Cross. They stand at their own 10.
Out of bounds!
Short kick.
Out of bounds!
You can hear Holy Cross yelling out of bounds, but it hits and stays inbounds. Jenkins picks it up, picking his way across the 20 to the 23-yard line. An alert play by Josh Jenkins. Took a UMass hop. It looked like he was going to hit and roll out of bounds. Instead, it darted upfield. And that's a live football.
And we talked about the starting field position. UMass has had tremendous starting field position all afternoon long. Holy Cross, quick little factoid from Phil Robo. This is the third straight drive Holy Cross has started at the 23-yard line. Not bad starting field position, but not what UMass has seen. UMass is starting everything basically from the 30 and on. Just starting, I believe, just 2 drives that they've started inside the 30. Nothing inside the 20. They haven't had a lot of adversity.
Mike Kielt on the toss sweep on first down. Gets the corner, gets a first down. And Kielt is brought down at the 39-yard line. So a 16-yard pickup for Holy Cross on first down.
And a lot of guys moving slowly after each play. UMass's defense, they've been on the field a long time as well. You saw it in Holy Cross's defense after the touchdown. Look at the big guys getting out in front. And Kielt just showing some speed to the outside, not a lot of reaction.
Terrence Gass, a couple guys on the deck. And Gass is run out of bounds by Brian Ellis, but he picks up 6 yards.
It's all conditioning right now in this heat and humidity. Late in the fourth quarter.
Holy Cross kind of trying to stretch that field a little bit and make those UMass defenders run.
Holy Cross has their complement of 3 timeouts remaining. UMass has 2.
Brock goes in motion. It's Gass on the handoff. And Gass is very close to a Holy Cross first down. It looks as though he has it from the spot here.
Plenty of time, plenty of football left in this one. The way these two teams go up and down the field, or can go up and down the field, there is a lot of football left. Terrence Gass, 9 carries, 43 yards. Unofficially, Mike Kielt, 9 carries, 40 yards in the game. These are Robo stats.
Here come the chains.
Here in the Holy Cross opener.
And Holy Cross has got a first down. And it's great to have Phil Robo back. We miss him. We have him in the wintertime, and then we get usually one visit during the summer and the spring with the Tornadoes. But we miss Phil Robo, and it's great to have him here for football because I think more than anything else, especially during a football game, you're telling a story. And Phil Robo and the Robo stats tell that game story.
Wow, I admire you.
Don't admire me, admire Phil. He's a wise man.
We're here speaking about a story.
How will this one end? We'll find out. The final 6 minutes and 9 seconds. Randolph to Gass. Gass eludes one tackle and gets down to the 44-yard line. Josh Jennings, the sure-handed linebacker, was the man who was out there. And Gass able to get through his tackle.
And we talk about conditioning at this time of the game, and what it tells me about Terrence Gass is this guy is in shape. Because he doesn't go down on the initial hit. He fights for 2-3 more yards.
UMass moving at the snap on the defensive line. Randolph on the keeper, and he slides for a first down. The UMass defensive line was still adjusting and still moving. Randolph calling for the quick snap, and they run an option. He keeps it and moves the chains.
This is a tired defense right now. Holy Cross has an opportunity to really make them hurt here in this drive. Dom Randolph just catches them all off guard and gets what he needs for the first down. We've seen Dom scramble. He is a threat to run the football. He's a hard runner. He gets the headlines with his arm.
Randolph from the shotgun on first and 10. UMass coming with the blitz. Randolph pressured, moves to his left. Here comes the rush, and Jennings gets him. Josh Jennings tracked him down.
Yeah, there you saw great speed from Jennings to get the angle on Randolph. Randolph's able to get back just about to the line of scrimmage. But this pocket closes quickly on Randolph. We don't see him scramble that often, but he had nothing downfield, and he couldn't see anything because the big bodies were closing in on him.
Josh Jennings went to Dean Junior College. Short distance down the road. Second down and 10. UMass showing blitz. Here they come. Randolph with time, going for it all, and Jenkins. Incomplete.
Al Davis just too big. You know, Jenkins just can't get around Davis, and Davis is in between Josh Jenkins and the football. Just too big a guy, and really he kind of runs off the route that Jenkins had. It's a good defensive play by the big defensive back, who's made some mistakes here this afternoon, looking to atone.
40th pass attempt for Dom Randolph. Big third down here for Holy Cross at the UMass 40. Minutemen coming. They pressure Randolph. Monette can't get him. Dixon can't get him. Randolph buys time. Underneath to Gass. Gass slips through a tackle and gets down to the 36-yard line. Brought down by Davis. And so you would guess that Holy Cross will go for it here on the 36. That 4-yard gain was huge.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question they're going to go. And almost had a Central Mass sack here. Anthony Momet, then Eric Dixon, and look at Dom Randolph, the athleticism. Getting around, and here we go. Big fourth down situation for Holy Cross.
Fourth down and 7. 3.5 minutes to play, and this crowd has come to their feet. Four wide receivers set for Holy Cross. Here comes UMass on the blitz. Randolph underneath. It is incomplete, but a flag flies.
Davis.
Davis was on the coverage of Luke Chmielinski, and that'll be a Holy Cross first down.
UMass brought the house up the middle. They brought a huge rush up the middle of the football field, and Holy Cross is going to catch a big time break here by getting the penalty on Davis. Throwing off the back foot, Davis gets his arm up, but he had his left arm on the receiver. Watch this, right over the middle of the football field.
Oh yeah, he's got him.
UMass is in disarray defensively, trying to get set. Holy Cross ready to go.
Kielt on the inside handoff. Kielt's got some running room. Still on his feet, down to the 21-yard line. That'll be another Holy Cross first down.
Credit that again. Holy Cross getting up, getting ready with the play. UMass was still getting set defensively.
Josh Jennings and Eric Dixon on the side.
Unless they were trying that Bill Belichick, everybody walking around, walk-up defense, but it didn't seem to work out there because Holy Cross with a big push up the middle. The center getting in front, Chris Smith leading the blocks up the middle.
Josh Jennings is down and being tended to. Jennings had 13 tackles a week ago, and he is walking off the field under his own power and had the huge interception late in the game against Albany that really sealed it.
And clearly UMass hoping that this is a cramp because they can't afford to lose Josh Jennings down the stretch here with Holy Cross driving.
Holy Cross, 3 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in this game for Tom Gilmore and his club. They still have all three of their timeouts remaining. The Crusaders trailing it by a touchdown, 42-35, UMass with the lead. UMass, the preseason pick to win the Colonial Athletic Association. Randolph on the money to Brock. Inside the 10, down to the 9-yard line. Another Holy Cross first down. It'll be first and goal, Crusaders. UMass has won back-to-back league titles. They were picked in the preseason to win again.
And Holy Cross picked second in the Patriot League, and there's a look at the perfect spiral from Randolph. And Brock just sitting down on the side here. Found some space, got inside the safety, the cornerback, and made a first down.
First and goal for Holy Cross. Randolph has time to the end zone. Touchdown! Touchdown, Freddie Santana. And Holy Cross is a point after away from tying this up.
Now you have to be careful when Dom Randolph is back throwing the football. I don't care how good you are as a cornerback, you can't take chances like that. And Santana was able to get better position on a much bigger guy in Jeremy Miles.
And how about the play of the offensive line, because they gave Randolph a lot of time. Partain's kick is up and through, and with 2:22 remaining, we are tied up at 42 apiece.
Now this offensive line has performed very well in this game. You know, three sacks, but this is probably against the best defensive front that they will see. Certainly one of the best. There's the room and time to throw. And for Santana to get inside of Miles, and Miles just reacting late after Santana got the inside position.
And remember about this defensive secondary for UMass. Three of the four preseason All-League picks, two of the three preseason All-Americans. Holy Cross is doing some damage against one of the toughest defensive squads in the country.
This is a very good defensive backfield, and they will be a very good defensive backfield. And Don Brown thinks they can defend the pass as well as anybody. Right now, other teams might be getting a scouting report on how to spread the field against this unit. And here we go in terms of special teams. 2:22 left, score tied at 42. And Holy Cross really needs a big play on special teams. They haven't, in terms of kick coverage, advantage kick return team on no matter what side you're on right now.
And we'll see what they do. You would expect that they would not kick the ball in the direction of Courtney Robinson or Jeremy Horn, the two deep men for UMass. Emil Iguanagu stands 15 yards in front of those two. Short pop-up, goes out of bounds. And UMass will have excellent field position. The Minutemen will start from their own 40. It's almost a lesser of two evils.
Yeah.
When you talk about kicking the ball away, do you take it at the 40? Well, in this case, you've seen if you don't, and they only tried it one other time, what Robinson can do to you. They wound up inside the Holy Cross 40.
Well, that's what it is right now in terms of you know, limiting the damage that UMass's special teams can do to you.
Now, the UMass kicker, Armando Cuco, has yet to attempt a field goal in his career. This is his first year starting as the kicker. He has been perfect on point afters, 4 for 4 last week and 6 for 6 today. Liam Cohen under center. Toss sweep to Nelson. Nelson cut down inbounds, so the clock will continue to run after a pickup of two.
Darryl Brown again coming up from the safety position. to make the stop. Good line of pursuit for Holy Cross. A lot of purple jerseys in on the play. Brown coming up to make the hit again.
Big time play by the senior co-captain. Under 2 minutes now remaining in the game. Cohen, complete. Out of bounds, it looks like it'll be short of the first down. Bailey was on the receiving end. But it does stop the clock with a minute 47 remaining.
Mashawi got him out of bounds, just shy of the sticks as he was trying to extend. UMass going quick.
Third and inches, Cohen on the sneak and a flag flies.
It's gonna be against UMass. I don't think they were lined up.
I don't think they were set.
They were not lined up right, not set. An illegal shift.
Oh boy. You go from third and inches to third and six. Third down and six, a minute 44 remaining.
Now mental mistakes have really hurt UMass in this game.
This right now is the biggest play defensively for Holy Cross of the afternoon. If they can hold here, they'll get the ball back. Four wide receivers in the game for UMass. Cohen has already thrown for over 300 yards. Underneath, but short of the first down. Andrew Cellino made the stop for the Crusaders. And it is going to be close.
Fourth and one at the 50 with a minute to play.
Wow.
And it's worth a timeout for Don Brown to talk about what you want to do. Cohen with time and a big hit right off the bat. That's what you got to do to Horn. You got to hit him right away. Otherwise, he's going to hurt you. And Cialino has done a nice job in that role for Ryan Stewart.
Cialino played in 7 games a year ago, had 4 tackles, but he is one of those young linebackers who has really stepped up today for Holy Cross. And what a big week we have coming up right here on Charter TV 3. On Thursday night, we kick off the high school football season. Shrewsbury at Auburn, live under the lights at 7 o'clock. Friday night, we've got the Frenzy, the first night of games for the Frenzy. And then Saturday afternoon, it'll be Holy Name and St. John's.
Liam Cohen, 23 of 31, 375 yards passing right now. Horn has been his main target, 158 yards on 10 receptions. And there is Tom Gilmore firing up his defense with the Rock, Richard Rogers.
Yep. Speaking of St. John's, Rogers' son, young and Richard Rogers, is
here we
a
go.
Wide receiver. And they are going to go for it. UMass, fourth and one. Cohen under center, going to run the option. Pitches to Nelson. Nelson has the first down as he dives forward for 5 yards. He went airborne at about the line of scrimmage, and he didn't land until he was 5 yards down the field.
Now UMass is going to get a stoppage of the clock when they reset the chains, and then they're right back up on the football, ready to go. Just one timeout left for the Minutemen.
Cohen rolls to his left. Has a little escort in front of him. Incomplete, but the wide receiver had run out of bounds anyway. It was Keemon Bailey who had been out of bounds, so it would not have counted. And now you've got some guys, some fresh bodies coming in there for Holy Cross. The Crusaders really need to try to get some pressure on Cohen.
Well, and they need to mark their man. They can't let Victor Cruz or Jeremy Horn get free. And they're the two guys on the top of your screen.
46 seconds remaining. Cross rushing 4. Bird gets some pressure on Cohen. He gets away, fires down the field, and incomplete. Evan Bird has played a whale of a football game, and he got some pressure on Cohen and flushed him out of the pocket. And Cohen was not able to hook up with his receivers on the run.
Holy Cross's defense, hey, 42 points are on the board, but they have stepped up in big situations here in the last quarter and a half, and they are making a big play there was Bird and forcing Cohen to basically just throw that away.
38 seconds. Third and 10 for UMass. Three wide receivers to the near side. Quick screen. Well defended, brought down in the field of play. Julian Talley.
Well, I'll tell you right now.
UMass is going to have to use their final timeout.
Michael Wright did a tremendous job of shedding his block and coming up to make that play.
That's a play that UMass has used today a few times and with some success.
Wright sheds his block, number three, and you'll see him come up, make the initial hit, and get credited for the tackle. A nice job by Wright. You see him get through his guy.
Yep. Gets up off the deck.
Joe Sanford, one of the better blockers in the UMass receiving corps, went down after him. Wright got around him, over him, and made the play. Fourth and five here, 41 yards away.
And UMass is out of timeouts, too.
UMass has to be wary if they turn the ball over here. And they are definitely wary of Tom Randolph's long arm ability.
Well, you mentioned the Harvard game and the feel it had. Dom Randolph leading his squad to an improbable comeback as he threw a bomb late in that game for the touchdown. That was to Thomas Harrison. Harrison has graduated along with Ryan Maher, the two leading receivers from a year ago. But in their stead, you have veterans like Brett McDermott and John Brock who have stepped up along with a host of sophomores today. 24 seconds left. Fourth down and five from the Holy Cross 41. Cohen, with time, has a man and a first down. Horn has it. He's out of bounds at the Holy Cross 26-yard line with 19 seconds remaining.
Now that's just confidence in your abilities, confidence in your offense, and the knowledge that you have a defense that can back you up if you don't convert here. And Horn is just wide open at the 30. I don't know how you can't have a guy. You see, the problem with Horn is if you get right up on him, he's going to run right by you.
Right.
And so he's kind of earned that respect, and that helps him create some space.
19 seconds remaining now. UMass out of timeouts. First and 10 from the 25. They give it to Nelson. He is cut down. And UMass is going to have to spike this football quickly, and they're going to have one shot at a field goal, and that's it. Cohen spikes it and kills the clock with 5 seconds remaining. So it'll be a 42-yard field goal attempt from Armando Cuco.
And this is a much different situation than in the first half when the wind was blowing in from the open end zone. There is no wind coming in now for Cuco in the 42-yard effort.
Tom Gilmore talking to the line judge. You would expect he's going to call a timeout, and he does. Trying to ice the kicker. 42-yard kick. You mentioned, though, no wind.
Well, very early in this game, Holy Cross went for it when it would have been a 48-yard field goal. The wind was blowing strong into the Holy Cross from the open end zone. And at that time, it was definitely the right decision early in the game. But now you've got no wind in a much more favorable situation for the UMass kicker. Cuco's out of Beverly, Massachusetts. Had a good spring for UMass, but really has no body of work here in terms of field goals coming into this kick. Biggest kick of his college career.
Here it is. 42-yard kick for Cuco. And Holy Cross calls another timeout. You got them, why not spend them?
Well, you can't take them with you, can you?
Nope. Well, this has been one heck of a football game, and certainly the folks that have come out here from the Central Massachusetts area have got to be pleased that these two schools have renewed their rivalry.
Now, 2 years in a row, Holy Cross has shown that they can go toe-to-toe with one of the top programs in the FCS. UMass, make no mistake about it, though they haven't played their best football this season, is a team that is a national contender. And they've been a national contender almost annually since 98.
Kuko's longest field goal in high school was a 40-yarder. He was 5 of 6 in his high school career for field goals. 42 yards for the win, and Holy Cross will use its final timeout. Kuko is well-traveled. Came to the United States when he was 14 years old from Italy, and he had moved from Albania to Italy when he was 8 years old.
Well, the UMass fans do not appreciate the 3 straight timeouts. And they serenade with a round of boos from the far side, and you really can't blame them. But this is the strategy of the near sideline.
Kuko was a soccer player as a freshman at Beverly High School, and then went out for the football team as a sophomore and had a tremendous career and played in the Shriners game as a senior. But he right now is on the biggest stage of his career, of his football career. Armando Kuko, the 5'11", 180-pound junior, 42-yard field goal for the win. The kick is up, he's got the length, and it is good. And that is the final play of the game. Armando Kuko, on the final play of the game, has kicked a 42-yard field goal. And UMass has escaped with a 45-42 victory here at Fitton Field. Well, this one went down to the very final play of the game. Kuko, the field goal from 42 yards out. And UMass escapes what would have been a huge upset.
Now, this is a big time kick from Kuko, and what a way to start things off for him. Tom Gilmore knows it as it's kicked through, and his team, another valiant effort in a big game against a nationally ranked team. But this one will sting for Holy Cross.
It will certainly hurt, but this, we're gonna take a break, and Andy and I will be back to wrap all this up right after these messages.